G-Man, and on federal election day, we vote in Premier Mark Brantley and the entire CCM party in seats 9, 10, and 11 for United St. Kitts and Nevis. Ha!
Yeah, 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 yeah. They are top 10, boy. We voted for CCM again. CCM, go keep it up, keep it up, up, up. Just keep it up, 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 up. Keep it up, CCM, keep up the momentum. Keep it up, up, up.
G-Man, on federal election day, we vote in Premier Mark Brantley and the entire CCM party in seats 9, 10, and 11 for United St. Kitts and Nevis. Ha!
This is Original Coffee representing for the CCM party. Mark Brantley, a year in the place, in a big up Alexis Jeffers and Eric Evelyn.
Some cry, some smile, some fight every day. We rise to the top, cause we know what it takes. Through it all, we survive, yet still hold the faith. Unchangeable, Lord, unchangeable. Hey,
this is Original Coffee, representing for the CCM party. Mark Brantley, a year in the place, in a big up Alexis Jeffers and Eric Evelyn.
Don't be a gruff now, no. Life is a journey, it's a long race. Mama says, son, be wise and don't bring disgrace. So me take off the broom and start sweep the place. Cause all these ways, they got to get erased. I love to me people that me embrace. The truth and I can't erase. So hell to all of those who want hate. Just send me to finish this race. So we ain't giving up now. We put up a fight. We got to unchangeable, Lord, unchangeable. Hey, no matter how the dollar might stack up, me still not change. Me, I go stay rough. In a diggity and you have to buckle up your legs. Be smart, don't be a gruff now, no. Life is a journey, it's a long race. Mama says, son, be wise and don't bring disgrace. So me take up the broom and start sweep the place. Cause all these ways, they got to get erased. I love to me people that me embrace. The truth are the truth and I can't erase. So hell to all of those who want hate. Just send me to finish this race. So we ain't giving up now.
No.
We put up a
not me.
And have one life when me too young for you worry about problems. Man, have one life when me too young, so I diss me and tell. Oh yeah, me say nothing me no worry about, yeah. Nothing me no worry about, lad. My life too sweet for the quip of the acid down. And I worry about money and girl. Me say nothing me no worry about, yeah. Nothing me no worry about, dog. Me happy man.
Chronics again. Head of a turbo bus. Bus what? Left some of them away at the bus stop. Not get the bus from the fall out. I can see them a bus. Ah, bro. Digital. 1-1. Chronics again. Head of a turbo bus. Bus what? Left some of them away at the bus stop. Not get the bus from the fall out. I can see them a bus back. I wait for the bus back. But guess what? Still I see I alone, me salute all red light of the trend, chronics a talky show. Me say me nah, do where Babylon want me do. Them dress in a straight jeans, me in a car. When me a the only man with pants for waist, me nah follow nobody. And when the old Jamaica bleach them face, me nah follow nobody. Tell them a me man, no me say one. Say go up a credit card, they buy a phone stand. And when a me alone, I sing righteous song. Me nah follow nobody. Them trend easy fi follow, you know easy fi set. No settle fi the less, I proceed fi the best. And if you think a lie, put me to the test. Give me a beat and I might be no need nothing else. You see them a drink rum, but me nah sip up. And me nah want jump till me can't get up. Me say me nah sing no song about the party book. What's me nah show me and the fancy bus. Me a the uncle man with
pants one way, so me nah follow nobody.
And when the old Jamaica bleach them.
Yeah, but wherever you're viewing this live, I wanna say good night to you. Good night to you. Make sure you share the live, all right? Big up yourself, share it, thank somebody.
One rasta you trend up pre-peer pressure. Now follow some trend and go pre-ear dress. Enough attack, say them and enough attack. Say them bad and when you go with them yard like Sabine be a setter. And a flask, flask who them say me na bus without a tattoo. Hey, I couldn't meet them a talk to. Them a figure settle the mechanics pass through. While when me a the only man with pants from waist. Now follow nobody. And if you know me, you know say I know.
No.
Put no trouble on my back. No.
From a city, lift them on both eyes first. Breathing the breath of life, so I pray.
watch over those like we. Smile with the rising sun. The creation we never hiding from. No negativity up in our high kingdom. I'm afraid by your child too.
My vibes. I'm not clear who I fight. I know I criticize. I'm on a higher height. So you can say what you want to and do what you want to. It's no concern to me. I'm coming up with one vision, but up on my one mission to rule my destiny. Oh, it's my day to do. I'm on a higher height. So you can say what you want to and do what you want to. It's no concern to me. I'm coming up more one vision, me dip on more one mission to rule my destiny. Oh, it's my day to do what
this is to. Coffee.
It's my time and I'll use it any way I want to. It's my life and I'm responsible for every action. It's all mine, my day, my time, my life. I beg your
good evening, everyone. A very pleasant good evening to our listeners who are tuning to VON Radio, the only powerhouse of the Eastern Caribbean, to those who are viewing on the various media platform, the internet. I want to say a very pleasant good evening to one and all. To those who are listening and viewing to us here in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis, our friends in the neighboring islands, the British and U.S. Virgin Islands, and certainly our friends as well up north, in North America, in Europe, in Canada, all the way down to Taiwan, we want to say good morning to you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a pleasure for us to be back here once again for this virtual meeting of your CCM party. I have been tasked with the chairmanship of tonight's activity, and as we often do in the great CCM tradition, we often commence our meeting with a word of prayer. And I want to use this opportunity at this time to offer a word of prayer. Holy and most gracious Father, we come to you once again with this virtual campaign meeting. We are doing it because of the global pandemic that have changed the way in which we do things. But we are thankful for the wonders of technology. That while we cannot physically go throughout the length and breadth of our beautiful island, we can come to our citizens via this marvelous tool of technology. We pray, O God, that you would bless all of our peoples here in St. Kitts and Nevis. Those who are feeling a bit down tonight for one reason or the other, we pray that you would comfort them. Those who are going through some difficult period in their life, we pray also that you would lift them up. To those who are sick, we pray that you would stretch forth your healing hand and cleanse their entire body. And I pray for those families who are in mourning tonight for the loss of a loved one, a friend or colleague, that you would comfort them, knowing that their loved one is rested in the loving arms of our Father, Creator. Take charge, O God, of tonight's proceeding and give all of our speakers a clearness of thought as they bring to the people from this platform honesty and truth. And pray that while we go through this campaign season, that the next week will be a week of non-violence, that we will not have any incident throughout this campaign season or what's left of it. And I pray that when all of the people of St. Kitts and Nevis go to the polls next Friday, that they will do so in a sense of peace and tranquility and calm, that they can elect a government of their choosing. And I pray that you would guide our people, that they will elect on the island of Nevis, your CCM party, and on the island of St. Kitts, our Team Unity colleague. That you will allow this federation to continue moving forward and upward. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are back here tonight. And I believe that as we continue on this virtual campaign journey, we continue to bring to the people of Nevis our plans and our aims for the next 5 years as members of our federal government. We recognize that the other side is engaging in some very nasty language. And I am a little bit troubled. I'm a little bit worried that instead of the putting before the people of Nevis serious projection for the island of Nevis, they are engaging in this kind of derogatory talk that seems to be the aim of denigrating others. And I want to say to the people of Nevis to stay focused. Stay focused, because all that I believe that they are trying to do is to try and create a distraction. They continue to create a distraction and getting you, the voters, upset towards the task that you have to do next Friday. And you, the people of Nevis, and you, the people of St. Kitts as well, must recognize what your task is. Your task, in my mind, is a very simple one. Your task, in my mind, is one that you must go to the polls come the 5th of June to stay the course. You must recognize that we have been on a course where we have seen a serious reduction in crime and criminal activity in our federation. I submit to you that no right thinking citizen of St. Kitts and Nevis would want to go back to the time of the heightened criminal activity that we suffered from under the previous administration. So stay the course. I want you, the citizens of St. Kitts and Nevis, to recognize that you must stay the course when it comes to our economy. The other side would have taken us at the seat of unprecedented debt in our federation. We, the ordinary man and woman in St. Kitts and Nevis, were finding it extremely difficult to survive in their homeland. I want you to stay the course, because you would recognize that it was team unity that have created the necessary enabling environment for our economy to grow and to expand. I want you to stay the course, citizens of St. Kitts and Nevis, and stay the course to ensure that we continue to reestablish the good name of St. Kitts and Nevis on the global stage. It pains me, under the previous dispensation, when the name of St. Kitts and Nevis was not a pleasant name globally. But we have seen that because of the hard work and the dedication and the commitment of this government, that the name of St. Kitts and Nevis is one such that is much more pleasant. Ladies and gentlemen, you have a choice. And the choice here on the island of Nevis is a simple one. But I want to say to the people of Nevis not to take anything for granted in this election. Let me say it again. I want to say to the people of Nevis not to take anything for granted in this election. The other side seem to be engaging in all kind of mischief, trying to create distraction, trying to create an environment where they are trying to confuse the voters. But Nevisians and residents, stay focused. Stay focused to the message of your CCM party. Because you can rest assured that your CCM party is coming to you with a message of truth and a message of hope, and a message that can guarantee you a better tomorrow. We are here offering you three candidates. In Nevis number 11, we have our Deputy Premier, the Honorable Alexis Jeffers. And I want to say to the people of Nevis number 11, St. James and St. Thomas's, give yourselves a chance. Give yourselves a chance to have a representative that will speak on your behalf, that will represent you at the federal level and ensure that significant benefits come to the constituency of Nevis number 11. When you look at the comparison, 20 years, 20 long years, that's a lifetime in politics. And the kind of achievement that one can achieve in 20 years in politics, but sadly, the NRP candidate who represented Nevis number 11 for 20 years have nothing to show. I want to say to the good people of Nevis number 11, give yourselves the chance. I recommend to you the Honorable Alexis Jeffers. Give him that opportunity to serve you for the next 5 years. And if it is that you feel that he did not do the appropriate job, then you will have a chance a next time to do whatever you need to do. St. James's, St. Thomas's, I encourage you to vote on the 5th of June for the Honorable Alexis Jeffers. Send him to Bastia. Send him to Church Street. Give him that opportunity to represent you at the federal level. In Nevis number 10, we have the Honorable Eric Evelyn. And I want to say to the people of Gingerland, I know that you have the formula for electing good, outstanding representation in Gingerland. You have done so for many years. And I want you not to change that formula at this time. You know the formula, and it has been working for many decades. So Gingerland, Nevis number 10, I am recommending to you your representative in the Honorable Eric Evelyn. Allow him the opportunity to serve you at the federal level. There is no comparison for the Honorable Eric Evelyn for the other side, from the other side. It's chalk and cheese. You know Eric Evelyn. He has been embedded in your community for many years. You know what he's capable of. You understand him and he understands you. So, the formula has been working in Gingerland. We want you on the 5th of June to ensure that you go to the polls and elect the Honorable Eric Evelyn as your next federal representative in Gingerland. And while you do that, I want you to also recognize that you will also be voting to ensure the legacy of your former premier that hails from Gingerland. I want you to also recognize that you would be cementing the continuation of that representation from Vance Winkworth Amri to Eric Rohan Evelyn in Nevis number 10. I am saying to you, stay on course in Gingerland. Stay on course in Gingerland. You cannot go wrong with Eric Evelyn in Gingerland. And we come to Nevis number 9, St. Paul's and St. John's. And I want to make an extra special appeal to St. Paul's and St. John's. Because you recognize that this constituency of Nevis number 9 has been one that has been filled with many trials and tribulation when it comes to election. We have seen the kind of awful things that they have done in this constituency that is the NRP when they were in power, when they were at the seat of government in this country. I want to say to the people of Nevis number 9, St. Paul's and St. John's, to stay the course. Stay the course with the Honorable Mark Brantley. Stay the course with our Premier. Stay the course with our Minister of Foreign Affairs. You would recognize that for many years, they have fought against the Honorable Mark Brantley, and they are trying it again. But I want to say to the people of St. Paul's and St. John's, the Honorable Mark Brantley's heart is in the right place when it comes to representation. He is eager to continue the representation to you at the federal level. He is passionate about ensuring that the island of Nevis obtain what is due to them. He wants to ensure that the development of our beautiful country continue on a path that we all can be proud of. But you, the voters, on the 5th of June, have to play your part. And you have a critical part to play. And your role is simply to ensure that you vote overwhelmingly for the Honorable Mark Brantley on the 5th of June in Nevis number 9, St. Paul's and St. John's. I believe that something special will happen after this election. I have a feeling that something special will happen after this election. Nevis number 9, St. Paul's and St. John's. Make sure that you are front and center and be a part of this historic prediction. I want you to ensure that after the votes have been tallied, that you would ensure that Nevis is sending to Bastia 3 representatives for the people of Nevis from your Concerned Citizens Movement Party. I want you to ensure that. And the only way in which you would be able to ensure that is if you go to the polls in numbers and vote for your CCM candidates. The decision should not be a difficult one. It should not be. You have seen these 3 gentlemen at work. Our Premier, the Honorable Eric Evelyn, and the Honorable Alexis Jeffers. You have seen them all at work. They are passionate about ensuring greater development for the island of Nevis. They are passionate about ensuring that Nevis moves further onwards and upwards. But they cannot do it alone. We cannot do it alone. We need your prayers. We need your support. We need your encouragement. And on the 5th of June, we need your vote. Because that will be the time when you will make a decision. And I once heard that elections have consequences. If by any stretch of realm of possibility or an imagination that the other side were to get on that side, you can rest assured that all that they would do is to try and create obstruction for the island of Nevis. And we cannot afford that. We cannot afford that in this environment, in 2020, when there are so many challenges for small island states. We cannot afford obstructions. So Nevisians, Kittishans, we are making our case to you. We are appealing to you. And we will do all that we can do and need to do. And then the rest will be up to you on the 5th of June. Tonight, our message is simple and our message is clear. We are not here to insult or denigrate anyone. We are simply here to bring you a message of hope for the future of our island and our federation. And we believe that we have the best team to represent the island of Nevis. We believe that these 3 gentlemen are best positioned to take Nevis forward at the federal level. The choice will be yours on the 5th of June. Do not squander the opportunity and vote for the other side. Do not allow them that privilege to get your vote. I would be the happiest man if on the 5th of June I hear that NRP gets 0. God, they are not worthy of your vote. Kind of things that they continue to say to the people of Nevis and about the people of Nevis, they are not worthy of your vote. And I'm saying it to you tonight. Because they continue to denigrate the people of Nevis. While we of the CCM continue to lift our people, because we have always said to you that people matter. It is all about you, the people of Nevis. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we have a number of speakers that will bring you the CCM message. And before I call the first speaker, I want to say to all of us who are, to all of you who are listening and viewing, I want you to call your neighbor, your friends, and your family, and to say to them, turn to the CCM virtual meeting. Turn to Von Radio, because you can rest assured that you will get something wholesome to listen to tonight and something decent to view tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, that was my opening remarks. And I would like to invite to the microphone our first speaker for tonight, the young, the talented, the youth amongst us, the Honorable Troy Youth and Libert, our Minister of Education and Library Services. Welcome to the microphone, the Honorable Troy Youth and Libert.
And not everybody I got like, we got like, still we hire it. Come in all of lights, in a dancer style. And not everybody I got like, we got like, still we hire it.
Thanks for the applause. Thanks for welcoming me. Good night, everybody. Everybody who's following via Von Radio, the Eastern Caribbean's only powerhouse. If you're watching us live on YouTube, welcome. And if you're viewing us on Facebook via our CCM Facebook page, welcome. And if you're on the live and you don't see your friend, send them a message quickly. Tell them to get on the live, because the CCM is live and we are campaigning here for election 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, as I was there sitting, listening to Minister Brand, and I want to thank Minister Brand for that introduction. But while I was there sitting and listening to him, you know, I was thinking, what am I going to say to the people of Nevis tonight in campaigning? Because I think the people of Nevis have heard most of it, you know. The people of Nevis know what's going on. They know that we have a federal elections. And they know that there's only one choice, really, in the federal election. And that's the three candidates for the Concerned Citizens Movement. And I don't think I had ever heard it put quite the way that Spencer just put it, that the NRP should really get zero. You know, when he said that, I thought about it, and I said, but it's true, you know. They should get zero, because when the people of Nevis put their trust in them in the past to go over to Bastia to represent us, you know what we got back in return? Zero. Zero. That is the sum total of the representation that we got for them. We know that the NRP, via Patrice Nisbet, the representative for Nevis 11, he was in the federal government from 2010 until 2015. And we all heard he was Minister of Justice and Legal Affairs and so on. And then he was Minister of Labor and so on, and Foreign Affairs. And who did he hire from Nevis? Who from Nevis could say they get a job? Well, other than Hector, who was brought on as soon as he lost his seat here in Nevis. He was brought on as an advisor and given a 7,000 plus salary. Other than him, who else got hired? Who else got represented? What did they do for the people of Nevis? And if you're honest, and we here in the CCM party, we like to be honest with the people. That is what we do. And if you're honest, you would realize that the sum total of the representation was zero. So come next week, Friday, I think it's only fitting that the people of Nevis give them zero, you know. That's the grade that they deserve. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been putting our plans forward for the people of Nevis about how the CCM, our candidates, the Honorable Eric Evelyn, the Honorable Alexis Jeffers, and the Honorable Mark Brantley will represent us here on Nevis, all of Nevis, at the federal level. We have seen the representation that we have gotten from 2015 to now. We have seen the results of it. The results of it, we have a lot of tangible things. The Mondo track, just across from here, such a beautiful thing. We go over there for interprimary. The last two interprimary sports that we have had have been the largest interprimary sports on Nevis ever. The first time we had the novelty of the track, everybody wanted to see the children running on the new track. But then the second year, we had more people than the first year. Why? Because our student athletes are given the opportunity to run on a first-rate, top-of-the-line track. And guess what? NIA did not have to incur any debt to bring that to you because of our relationship with the federal government. The federal government has access to the CBI funds, and the people of Nevis should have access to those funds. You all remember the campaign in 2015? We spoke about that day in and day out, that how the NRP had been in government in St. Kitts, and they did not bring back much. The only thing we got at that time from that relationship was loans. Had to take out loan for the airport and so on, the airport lands. And they didn't even put the money through the treasury. That shows that there was something sinister going on there. The monies came up through NIPA and through the craft house. Biggest money ever come through the craft house account was for that. They didn't even say, well, leave some money in the craft house account to fix up the craft house. They take it straight and it went to whoever it went to. I remember I was on the radio with one gentleman at the time, and he was there banging his mouth on the radio as usual, talking in his accent about all of the different things. And when the moderator of the show came to me and he said, well, Mr. Liebert, what do you think? I said, that gentleman has 4 million reasons to be talking. That's why he's talking so much, and that's why he's talking so fast. Because that was the final destination for it, you know. The final destination. You see, so that was their representation. Our representation brought them on the track. That's what we do here in CCM. We all remember when the treasury burned down. Most of us felt bad about it. Some people laughed about it. But guess what? We have a new treasury down there. We didn't have to go and incur any debt to do that. In the normal workings of things, that is what we would have had to do. But because of that relationship, and because we got the access to our share, or some of our fair share from the whole CBI arrangement, we were able to do certain things like those. The NIA has gotten some flexibility because of those things. And that is the type of representation that we are talking about in campaign 2020. Now contrast that, because we got to run against somebody, you know. So contrast that to the representation that the other side is saying that they're coming in. Well, I haven't heard the gentleman in 11 with any plans for what he planned to do. So I guess he wants to go to St. Kitts to do more of the same thing that he has done for the past 20 years, which amounts to zero. You understand? That is the sum total of his plans. Just go back and do the same thing over and over again. See if you could get back down. See if you could bring back in a partner again as an advisor. And I don't know what else. But I haven't really heard any plans. The gentleman from up the road in Gingerland, well, he planned to clean off the mountainside and plant some vegetable trees and some fruit trees. You understand? That's it. And I heard him say something about jobs, 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 jobs. And he was there singing. And then we have the other gentleman. And, you know, in his mind, he's a really, really smart person. Understand? The other one in nine. And his plans. Well, what are his plans? So you go on Facebook. And you look on the page and you see they plan to build this big housing project in Bath, $40 million, okay? Nice looking render and all of that of what the housing project gonna look like. So people go on Google and they start to do a little search and they find the same housing project on Google. So imagine, these guys are telling you, we want to represent you. We are going to be presenting plans and so to you, and they don't even have enough respect for the populace of Nevis, for the people of Nevis to say, get somebody and sit down and come up with a plan that could actually work. No, they go on Google, they search, and the first thing they find, they copy and they paste, and they say, okay, this is our plan. And they come before the people of Nevis. You understand? And I want you all to think about this. They call it M.O. M.O. Modus operandi. It's how somebody operates. You understand? Because a man or a woman is who they are, you know. I am who I am. They are who they are. And people seldom change. Eh? So you have to look at somebody for who they are now and understand what they're going to be when they get into government. Imagine. Before you could get into government and get any kind of power. People say when you're in government, you got power. I don't really know about that, okay? And I've been in government for a while. I think government is service. I don't know about the power part of it. But imagine, before you could even get into government, you already start referring to people as house negroes and termites, okay? Imagine before they get a little bit of power, they're already calling people house negroes and termites. And what you all think gonna happen when they get a little power? What do you think is gonna happen when you vote for them? What do you think they're gonna start to call you then when they got a little bit of power? If they don't have any now, and they're already referring to people as house negroes and termites, I don't want to imagine what they're going to start to call people when they get a little bit of power. And Nevis people have to remember, you know, when you give NRP a little bit of power and they feel like, man, people taking back the power from us, you know, they are willing to go to any length to keep it. You all remember election in Nevis in 2011? CCM got into office in 2013, but there was an election just a few years before that, 2011. And what happened coming up to the 2011 election? Man, husband and wife live in the same house together. Husband support CCM, wife support NRP. Sorry, your wife? Or vice versa. But whoever supports CCM, they pull the name off the list. And the one that support NRP, that name remain on the list to vote. Why? Because they realized that they weren't going to win at the poll, but they wanted to win and they were willing to do whatever it took to win. They did not want to let democracy prevail. Now remember I told you all about modus operandi. we have to be careful of these people, because you give them an inch, they're going to run and take a mile. When you look at CCM and you look at our candidates not here to rule people. No, our candidates are here to serve. And guess what? They go out and they do a good job. And then they come back to the people and say, judge us by our works and give us an opportunity to continue working for you. And in this federal election, we are saying, judge us by our works as a party. Judge our candidates by their works and give them an opportunity to continue to work. And as a matter of fact, we want an increase, because we've had 2 seats. We want to get 3 seats to go back over to St. Kitts with, so that we can do more for the people of Nevis. But guess what? CCM is not trying to hijack the electoral office. We're not trying to do any of those things. We are willing to work with the electorate as it is. We are willing to work with the system. We're not here to push people around. The Honorable Mark Brantley has been in government for a long time. The Honorable Alexis Jeffers has been in government for the same amount of time. The Honorable Eric Evelyn is a little bit newer, but I'm sure you have not heard any of them refer to the people of Nevis in any derogatory ways. And they're already in government. And if people say, when you're in government, you have power, they already have power. And they respect people. We don't see that on the other side. If those guys don't even have a little power yet, and they're already referring to people as house Negroes and termites, just imagine what they will do if you, the people of Nevis, give them a little bit of power. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching us on the live, if you're watching us on YouTube, or if you're listening on Van Radio, I want you to listen carefully, you know, because this election is a serious election. The choice is a simple one. The candidates of the Concerned Citizens Movement. But the choices that we make have consequences. You choose the Concerned Citizens Movement, you will meet good, because you will have persons there to represent you. You know, ladies and gentlemen, they have this clip sending around. Candidate running against the Honorable Mark Brantley. And you listen to them talking, and I watch in the clip and I saying, they're talking a lot of nonsense. No wonder B and Jap sleep, and no wonder Hensley are holy head. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just a whole lot of nonsense they're talking. Gentleman was on a live a couple minutes before. Somebody called me and said, well, they call your name on the live. So I watched the live. I didn't even bother about them calling my name. But back to this modus operandi, the gentleman said, when CCM got into government, we met debt, 180 million. That is what you call a blatant lie. And you know, when people having these shows and so on, one of the things I would advise is that you fact check people who come to talk. Because I know that the total dispersed debt for the NIA when we got into government was already in excess of 400 million. And you all know I like facts. If you all know me, you know I like facts. So I'm going to come back with the facts one of these nights this week when I have a little time to talk. Tonight is only a little teaser. So I'm going to come back with the facts, eh? Because the gentleman said 180 million, and that is what you call a lie. Goes back to modus operandi. If they're going to tell you lies to try to get the vote and to try to get in government, what do you think they're going to do when they're in government? it will be more lies. So what you need to do, ladies and gentlemen, is to support the party, support the candidates that will come to you with the truth and that will try to give you an honest day's work every single day. And I can tell you for a fact that the candidates being put forward by the Concerned Citizens Movement, all three of them, I can tell you because I work with them every single day, that they are hard-working people and that they have the best interests of the people of Nevis at heart. And when you send our candidates, the Honorable Eric Evelyn, the Honorable Alexis Jeffers, and Premier Mark Brantley over to St. Kitts to represent you, the people of Nevis, the island and people of Nevis will be well represented and well taken care of for the next 5 years. Thank you and good night.
Big up Alexis Jeffers and Eric Evelyn. My brother, I hear it.
They are top 10 ball. We vote for
CCM. Thank you very much. And ladies and gentlemen, I hope by now you recognize that the Concerned Citizen Movement Party have a lot of talent. And you know, somebody said something very instructive to me the other day. That why is it that the NRP was up and down the place suggesting which candidate the CCM should choose to run in Nevis number 11? And the person. And I had a little discussion with the gentleman. And the person said to me, well, why is it that they want to choose the candidates that CCM must run in a particular constituency? And we discussed it for a moment. But the gentleman also said, but that is not the problem, you know. They're trying to tell CCM which candidate CCM must run or which candidate CCM must choose to run in a particular constituency. But here's their problem. They can't find candidates for themselves to run in their own constituency.
No. He wasn't ready.
You understand? They want to get involved in CCM business. As to who must run, or who should run, or who shouldn't run. But they can't find candidate. Now, when you look at up Gingerland, you have a lot of people up there making noise. Lot of them. A lot of them up there have a lot of things to say. Not one of them bold enough to put their name on the ballot. They had to go back to
the rejected one.
Listen, let me tell you something, right? Ladies and gentlemen, if the NRP now were good for them, they must leave CCM alone. They must mind their own business. And leave you. Oh, say it again. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight you would recognize that we are just about 1 week away from this election once we hit midnight tonight. And I want the people of Nevis in particular to recognize that the next week on the island of Nevis would be a very testing one. And I've had the great privilege of sitting at the feet of men like Vance Amory in the CCM party I have had the privilege of sitting at the feet of men like Colin Tyrrell, Livingston Herbert. I have had the privilege of looking from a distance as how this marvelous and wonderful lady called Nurse Jean operate and function. And one thing that always stood out for me with these persons, they have always sought to lift up the people of Nevis. Well, there was one unique instance in Parliament when the former Premier made a statement. I will not repeat his statement. I think it is in the annals of our parliamentary history. When he called a gentleman on the other side a particular name. And while the former Premier apologized to the Speaker of the House, he said, I still believe that he is a... Ladies and gentlemen, tell them to leave CCM alone. Tell them if they want to discuss the issues about moving this country forward, they can come and have that discussion. Minister Leibert spoke about what the lying master said. And he continued to lie on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, and on a monthly basis, what he said. And I'm going to get to that a little later, because I hope the people of Bath Village are paying attention. I hope the people of Nevis are paying attention to the kind of rhetoric that is being uttered from their lips. I hope Bath Village is listening. And I know that they are listening. Because out of Bath Village, we have the powerhouse of the Eastern Caribbean. Ladies and gentlemen, join with me as I welcome to the microphone our next speaker, the Honorable Eric Evelyn, to address you.
My name is Eric Evelyn. I am the era representative for St. George. In the midst of all my fears, I cried to my Savior, and he heard my every prayer. He said, So I wipe up the night, and I look towards the sky. I believe I should be given that not.
Yes, I!
To go
yes, 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 yes,
yes,
Yeah. night, good night, good night. You know I can dance to anything. Calypso, reggae, gospel, anything. And you know what? It's because I can dance better than them, they grudge too. They grudge for that too. Ladies and gentlemen, good night. It's a pleasure once again to be here on the platform of the Concerned Citizens Movement. And I want to start tonight with a few verses from the Bible. Yes, I'm going to start tonight with a few verses from the Bible. I'm going to start with Psalm 24, verses 4 and 5. He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sown deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Isaiah 54, verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. James 1, verse 12. Blessed is the man who perseveres under trial, because he hath stood the test. And finally, from Matthew 5, verses 11 and 12. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Sound words from the Bible that cannot be condemned. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, we of the Concerned Citizens Movement, we are God-fearing people. We all know that. Every night we come here, we start with a prayer, because we know the importance of inviting God's presence with us. And you know, the reason why I brought these Bible verses tonight, because persons from the other side, the supporters of the other side, they are trying their best to keep us out of focus, but that won't happen. This party is focused. The leadership that is coming from the Concerned Citizens Movement, we will remain calm. We will focus on the goal. We will focus on the prize. And the prize is, on June 5th, 2020, all three for we in 2020, 9, 10, and 11.
CCM, go with it.
And irrespective of what they're going to say, they're trying all kind of things now at the 11th and the 12th and the 13th hour. But they're not going to work. They will not work. We are marching towards the prize. And I can smell the victory already. And so I want to tell my colleagues, the Honorable Alexis Jeffers and the Honorable Mark Brantley, do not be flustered by all of the noise. And I like to say all of the garbage. Because you know what? When I was running in 2017, I said to the people of Nevis that the garbage that was going to be thrown at me, and that will be thrown at me during this election as well, I told the people of Nevis, I could remember vividly, right over on the Brown Hill Hard Court, I said on election day, the garbage will go exactly where it belongs, to the dump. And that is where it went. And so for this election, in 2020, the garbage will go back to the dump. Whatever garbage means is being thrown to us, we'll collect the garbage and throw the garbage on the dump. And in the end, we will remain with our clean hands and we will be elected to office in the Federal Assembly. I want tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and I want to say a special good night to all those who are watching and those who are listening. There are persons who go on religiously every night, and when we are not on, they are wondering what is happening with CCM. But of course, we have to take a break now and again because we are only human. And of course, you know, when we come, we're full of vigor and we're full of energy. Nobody on stage falling asleep. Nobody fall asleep up here because we got the energy, we got the vibes, we got the momentum, and we're keeping the momentum. All the momentum we have, it's only increasing. It's going to increase and increase and increase until the 5th of June. And then we keep that momentum straight into Bastia, straight to Church Street. And so, I want to tell the people of the Concerned Citizens Movement, all the members of the party, all the supporters of the party, when you hear nonsense, dispel the nonsense and read a few verses from the Bible. And that will keep you going, that will keep you calm, that will keep you steady, that will keep you focused. I want tonight to say a special thank you to the two persons and of course all the supporters who were there with us yesterday. Morally, of course, we were not able to have much supporters, but I know persons who are following on Facebook and persons who are following the developments, because yesterday was nomination day. And with the three of us being nominated for the Concerned Citizens Movement, the dream team is now one step closer to victory. We are one step closer to the victory. And I want to say a special thank you to the persons who nominated me, Mrs. Deslyn Evelyn and Mr. Burley Walwin. And I want to say a special thank you as well to the Honorable Mark Brantley and the Honorable Alexis Jeffers for allowing me the privilege and the honor to be a part of the Dream Team. And have no fear, my good people of the Big Blue Machine, this Dream Team is going to get the victory. And I was particularly pleased yesterday. You know why? Because I was nominated at the David Freeman Center of Excellence. And you know why I was so proud to be nominated there? Because that is a project in the heart of Gingerland that was criticized by the opposition. Because, you know, they criticize for everything. And yesterday when they were there, I was wondering if they're in shame. I was wondering, I wonder if these people are in shame. All of what they got to say about the David Freeman Center of Excellence. You know what I mean? They say we spend too much money up there. They say it's a waste of time. But I can tell you that I was so proud to walk in that edifice yesterday called the David Freeman Center of Excellence and be nominated to have my name placed on that paper to say I have been nominated in Nevis 10 to represent the Concerned Citizens Movement in the federal election.
Big up Alexis Jeffers and Eric Edmund.
It was a proud moment for all of us. This, of course, is my debut. My grand debut on the federal political stage. And I feel just as confident in this election that I was in the Nevis Island Assembly elections. And you know, since I'm talking about the David Freeman Center of Excellence in Gingerland, something that has, I would say, my name written all over it, and the people of Nevis and the cabinet name written all over it, I have been outlining to you, night after night, ladies and gentlemen, the need to send the three of us to Bastia. And I've been making the case, night after night, that we of the Dream Team of the Concerned Citizens Movement, we are by far the best team to represent the people of Nevis in the federal elections. We are by far the best team. And of course, we also have to keep reminding you every night as well that this is not a Nevis Island Assembly election. This is a federal election where we are looking at federal issues. I'm aware that there are some on the other side who cannot make the distinction. But we are going into a federal election and we must look at things that impact us federally. And one of the things that I am in charge of, one of the portfolios that I hold, that impact us federally is the area of culture. I don't drink me water, but I now drop sleep. Right? One of the areas that we collaborate between the two islands with is the area of culture. And you know, when they were making sort of hullabaloo about the David Freeman Center of Excellence, these people are not aware of how important culture is to the people of St. Kitts and Nevis and to the people of the region. And I am so happy that I was given the portfolio of culture. I guess Mark knew that I can dance. That's why he gave me the Ministry of Culture.
Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? And so culture is one of those portfolios that we always collaborate with between St. Kitts and Nevis. We have spent a lot of money here on the island of Nevis upgrading our cultural facilities. We have spent some serious money on the cultural complex. We have spent some serious money on the cultural village. And we just spent some money on the David Freeman Center of Excellence. And every time we spend money upgrading and enhancing these facilities, we are criticized roundly. Now tell me, all of us in Nevis know how people on Nevis and St. Kitts look forward to culture. And so we spend the money to develop our culture, to develop our art forms, to assist the persons who have their talent, the Calypsonians and the Queen contestants. And the good thing about it is that we as a federation embrace Culturama both in St. Kitts and Nevis. And that is why when we have Culturama, we have so many from persons from St. Kitts coming to either take part or just be a spectator for the Culturama activities. And so this is an area where St. Kitts and Nevis are always intertwined and always working together. And I want to publicly thank the people of St. Kitts for always supporting, overwhelmingly supporting our Culturama. And it's always heartening when we see even troops from St. Kitts coming over to take part in the festival. And of course, we have realized as well that from our Culturama festival, we are also now infiltrating the carnival on St. Kitts. I think it was only last year for the carnival, and the year before, we would have sent a contingent from Nevis to take part in the street activities over in St. Kitts. And what an impression we made there. Collaboration, St. Kitts and Nevis, culture, carnival. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure most of you would have heard about Carrie Festa last year. And what a hit the contingent from the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis made at Carrie Festa in the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And I'm here to tell the good people who are listening and who are watching, the good people of St. Kitts and Nevis, our good friends and family in the diaspora, that we of the Concerned Citizens Movement, continue to place great emphasis and importance on the development of culture. Culture and tourism, our main engine in economic development, they are inextricably linked. Because when we have the tourists coming to our shores, remember that nowadays the tourists are not only coming for sea and sand and sunshine, they are coming to experience something different. And that is why this government, with foresight, has placed some emphasis on the development of culture. You know, I attended a culture meeting last year in Barbados with all of the culture ministers from across the region. And I was amazed at the budgets, the type of budget that these ministries from the other parts of the region were pumping into the development of culture. And I want to say that as the Minister of Culture on the island of Nevis, I will continue to push, because our cultural ambassadors on the island of Nevis can reach far and they can make money, and we are interested in your development. When we had Carifesta in Trinidad and Tobago, we had a contingent from the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. And I am proud to say that the 12-member contingent from Nevis, they represented and represented well. The entire contingent from the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis represented and represented fantastically. And I must give special kudos to our masqueraders from Nevis, because they were a hit in Trinidad and Tobago. Wherever they went, they were loved, they were embraced. And guess what? Because of the fact that the island of Nevis would have seen it fit to send these cultural ambassadors to Carifesta 14. And of course, I must give kudos to the federal government for the assistance that was given in sending the entire contingent to Trinidad and Tobago. Ladies and gentlemen, I am saying that the performances from our cultural ambassadors at Carifesta will never be forgotten. Some of the guys who went to Carifesta have been to Carifesta before, and they have admitted that this was by far the most impactful for them and the one that they will always remember the most. And guess what? This was the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis working hand in hand. Because guess what? The Minister of Culture from St. Kitts, the Honorable Sean Richards, he could not make it. And I was happy to stand in. I was happy to stand in as the leader of the delegation from the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. And I'm proud to say that I led the delegation with distinction. A proud Nevisian who is now asking you to send me to Bastia to continue to represent you. Look at the files. Look at the comments from Carifesta. And you will realize how well I represented Nevis and I represented the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis at a regional festival that was being viewed the globe, all over the globe. And we, as the CCM Nevis Island Administration, will continue to work with the government in Bastia to continue to push culture. I would also say that when I was a part of that contingent to Carifesta, I was the only Minister of Culture, and I'm proud to say, I was the only Minister of Culture who followed the delegation everywhere they went, and not only followed the delegation, I got down with them as well. Everybody saw me? Yeah. Who can doubt that I did a good job in Trinidad and Tobago? I had so many comments from the people in Trinidad and Tobago, yes, saying, yes, that they can't believe that's a minister, so involved with the people. So involved, but that is what a politician is supposed to do. And that is what I've been doing even before I got into politics. And that is what I will continue to do. And that is why you will send me to Bastia, to continue to represent and represent you well.
Yes,
I have shown my mettle that I can not only represent Nevis, but I can represent the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis.
Yes,
and it was shown very plainly and very clearly at Carifesta 14 in Trinidad and Tobago. The news items are there. The newspaper clippings are there. The interviews are there. I remember on the first night of the Carifesta, I was up in the stand at the Savannah, and all the ministers of culture had on their jacket. I had on mine too. And when they said, St. Kitts and Nevis delegation going on stage, I told the other ministers, I'm sorry. I'm taking off my jacket. I'm going down on stage with my contingent. No other minister did that. None. And the evidence is there to prove it. And I want to say as well that Carifesta 15 will be coming up in Antigua, Barbuda next year. And I'm looking forward to that. Because I'm going to go back to represent St. Kitts and Nevis again. And I'm going to put on my dancing shoes again. And you know the problem too? When I was in Trinidad and Tobago, representing the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis, people were up here having a problem with me. People were up here in Nevis having a problem with me. Well, you're going to always have the problem with me. Because I'm going to represent and represent well. I will always be a part of my people from the Federation. Wherever I go, I will integrate with them. And some of them can't do that. That's why they're jealous. And that is why I am going to go to Bastia with a resounding victory on the 5th of June. And still talking about Carifesta, I have a feeling, I have a feeling that in the near future, the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis will vie to host Carifesta. We haven't hosted the festival for a long time. And whenever that time comes, if it comes, I, as the Minister of Culture, and I pledge the support of the Nevis Island Administration, that we will collaborate and work well with the federal government to host the festival. As I look at the David Freeman Center of Excellence, you know what I said? This government is always a government of foresight. Because whenever the time comes again for St. Kitts and Nevis to host Carifesta, that will be one of our venues. Right up there in the heart of Gingerland. Foresight on behalf of the CCM. Foresight for our cultural ambassadors. Foresight for us to push our culture forward. Foresight for when we have our tourists to come, our cultural ambassadors can show off their culture. And you know what as well? It is foresight when we make the enhancements of the cultural village and the cultural complex. Because I know when people from throughout the region and throughout the diaspora come to the shores of St. Kitts and Nevis and they visit Nevis and they see our cultural sites, our cultural venues, they will be very pleased that a small island like Nevis could be able to produce this. They will be proud. And I will be proud, the Nevis Island Administration will be proud, and you as Nevisions will be proud. And so, we stand by our decision to continue to work with our cultural ambassadors, our cultural art forms, to develop culture to the highest degree. And I want to pledge that when I get to the federal government, that will continue. Because culture is an area where the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis works very, very closely. At present, we are in the heart of a project sponsored by UNESCO, Intangible Cultural Heritage. Here again, St. Kitts and Nevis collaborating. The project is taking place in Nevis as well in St. Kitts. And we are now working together more than ever. The Department of Culture on St. Kitts, the NCDF, the Culturama Secretariat, and I can pledge to you that relationship will continue after the 5th of June, because I am confident that the CCM will prevail, irrespective of all of the negativity. Our God is bigger than anything. Bigger than anything. And we are bigger than anything they can throw at us. We are bigger and will remain bigger. We will stand tall over in St. James. We want you to continue to throw your support behind the Honorable Alexis Jeffords, because he has earned the reputation of being the hardest working minister on the island of Nevis.
Alexis Jeffords.
Even though I don't believe he worked hard on me.
Big up Alexis Jeffords.
Alexis. That's just Alexis a joke. Jeffords. But Alexis has earned that reputation. Always on the ground. Always rolling up his sleeves. And you will find an excellent representative in Alexis Jeffords. The Honorable Mark Brantley in Nevis 9. You know, what can we say about the Honorable Mark Brantley that you haven't heard? And you know, the Honorable Mark Brantley is such a bright and intelligent politician that, Lord have mercy, they grudge that poor fellow too bad.
Mark Brantley, a year in a place, you know.
They grudge that poor fella too bad. And the jealousy is rubbing off now, you know, because they're not only jealous, he is coming over to me now. But as I've been told, and I will repeat, there is no cure for grudge and envy and jealousy. There is no cure for that. But guess what? The more you grudge, the more you're jealous, is the more we in the CCM and the more the party will prosper. Because God is on our side. No matter what you say, God is on our side. And we will always prevail. And so, I am confident that the Honorable Mark Brantley will prevail in Nevis 9. The Honorable Alexis Jeffords will prevail for the first time at the federal level in Nevis 11. And up in Nevis 10. The only little problem I see, right? The only thing that's giving me a little scare is the fact that Nevis 10 got in a lot of donkeys. And if all of them got voter ID, I in big trouble. I am going to be in big trouble. So I hope the electoral office did not issue any voter IDs to them. Because, you know, they ain't going to vote for me.
No.
You know they ain't going to vote for me. So I have, apart from that little fear, I don't have any fear whatsoever. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to underscore the point that you've been hearing night after night, day after day, that the three Hebrew boys with clean hands, with a clean reputation, we are the ones who you should consider to send to Bastia to represent you. And I'm very confident, because the people of Nevis are very intelligent people. And I want to tell the Honorable Alexis Jeffords, you're the Minister of Agriculture. And the first thing I want when I win is some vegetable trees. That's the first thing I would want when I win. So ladies and gentlemen, make no mistake, on election day, June the 5th, 2020, a historic day for Nevis, when it's all a three for we in 2020, vote the Honorable Mark Brantley in Nevis 9, yours truly in Nevis 10, and the Honorable Alexis Zook Jeffords in Nevis 11. And we will always continue to champion your cause and give you the best representation ever. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, good night, God bless you, and have a wonderful night.
Yes, tell you the man ready. The man ready, ready, ready. You know, ladies and gentlemen, while the Honorable Eric Evelyn was up here making his presentation, and he started to talk about his exploits in Trinidad, representing the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis at Carrie Festa. You know, my phone started to light up with some pictures of him actually in Trinidad at Carrie Festa. So the man wasn't telling a lie. And when I get the pictures, I smile, you know, because I say, boy, the other side, they could tell a whole lot of lie. But where the cameraman? I want the cameraman to focus on the phone. Where is the cameraman? Yeah, come. I want you to zoom in and see. When you get it, give me a thumbs up. That's right. In Trinidad, when the other side speak, all I talk about is a whole lot of lie. You know, I was watching some news a couple days ago, and I noticed that Twitter have now started to fact check the President of the United States of America. And I said to myself, what it is happening, that it seems to me that truth is no longer worth anything. And when you think of something like that, where the internet have to fact check a president, it leaves a lot to be desired. And I want to say to the people of Nevis, you don't need to fact check anything that you are getting from the CCM platform. When we come here, we bring to you the truth. And I smile because when Honorable Eric Evelyn was up here talking about Trinidad and dancing and representing, boom, the pictures came. Man in Trinidad carrying the St. Kitts and Nevis flag, dancing and carrying on in Trinidad. But when the other side talk, they need Twitter to fact check them. They need Facebook to fact check them. They need Instagram to fact check them. Because all they do is to tell a whole lot of lie. And they do it on a monthly, a weekly, and a daily basis. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is all that you're going to get for the next 7 days. A whole lot of lies and propaganda. And you know, I have the privilege of being on a program at Von Radio. And right in the room, in a very conspicuous corner, is the word propaganda and the meaning. And sometime when we are going down a certain path, the host would say to us, look over your shoulder and look at that little word behind you, propaganda. Ladies and gentlemen, we are not coming to you with any propaganda. We are coming to you with the facts. We are coming to you with a vision for St. Kitts and Nevis. We are coming to you with the truth. We are coming to you with a message of hope. And you've heard the Honorable Eric Evelyn outline a number of initiatives that he would have been a part of since taking the reins in government, and in particular, the Minister of Culture. And that is the vision that we want to see for Nevis and for St. Kitts and Nevis. Where when we come on this platform, we can say to you where we want to see our country go. And ladies and gentlemen, all that we are getting from the other side, they're like they're on a mission to denigrate the people of Nevis. But I want you, the people of Nevis, to fix them and to fix that on the 5th of June. I want you to send them a clear message that enough is enough. And when you go to the polls, in Nevis number 11, I want you to send the Honorable Alexis Jeffers to Bastia. Welcome him, ladies and gentlemen, to speak to you at this time. The Honorable Alexis Jeffers.
My name is the Honorable Alexis Jeffers.
But he will never, 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 never control me. Darkness walks behind me.
Behind me.
But he will never, 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 never control me. Today I live a life of sorrow, working for the joys of a bright tomorrow. Carrying my cross. Carrying my cross. Carrying my cross.
Why you cut this out? Provide a little entertainment. Okay, well, I suppose it means I should begin my presentation. I want to start by saying good night to everyone who is listening via Von Radio and also who are viewing on Facebook, Twitter, what else? All of the social media platforms out there, YouTube. I think we're going far and wide throughout the entire world. This is now Thursday. I believe today is the 28th day of May. So we have just a few more days before Election Day, which is June 5th, 2020. I believe someone said before that we have just about a week left. And when we started this journey, just about 2 weeks ago, we erected this stage and we said we are coming to Caribbean Cove, and we're going to put on a display here that can almost duplicate what we would have done under normal circumstances. But we are going virtual, and we have been going virtual for the last 2 weeks. And the reviews that we have had is that the campaign, albeit that we do not have a huge crowd here in front of us, persons have been following us night after night and have enjoyed our discourse. And you know why they have enjoyed our discourse? It's because we have come to you with the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And because of the respect that we have for the Nevisian public, because of the respect that we have for the entire Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis, and because of the respect that we have for citizens throughout the world, we have kept a certain standard here during our deliberation on our discourse to ensure that what we divulge and what we speak about is palatable to all who listens. And as such, I want to maintain that standard tonight, and I want to commend all of the speakers before me who would have come this evening and have brought to you clean, wholesome information that you can certainly digest. But ladies and gentlemen, tonight I want to be a little bit different. Every night we try to come and we can rev it up sometimes. We come and we are a bit more, not necessarily somber, but at least we are a bit more controlled in our approach. But we've always come with what I consider a sober mind and have presented sober information. Well, you know, we are campaigning, and I've gone throughout my constituency of Nevis 11. I've gone to the entire St. Thomas Parish. I've gone through the entire St. Thomas Parish and also the entire parish of St. James. And you know, we have our lovely campaign paraphernalia, bag filled with goodies, shirt, whistle, headphone, watch. And you know, when we order these things and we put these items together, we know that persons are going to gravitate to them. So I want to say this evening, those of you who have not yet received your campaign paraphernalia, I'm coming to you. But I love going through the communities and handing out these paraphernalia myself. Most times I go, and that is my way of presenting that package and also listening to the ideas and the concerns of the citizens and residents of Nevis 11. So I've been going throughout the length and breadth for the last couple of days. And everywhere I drive to and everywhere I go, the NRP follows me. Someone from the NRP, I should say. Not only someone, but sometimes a team from the NRP follows me. Today I was in Cotton Ground. A certain gentleman told me to get out of Cotton Ground, an NRP foot soldier, I call him. And I didn't engage him, but I can say to him that I've done more in Cotton Ground for than he has ever done. More for the people of Cotton Ground. I want to say to the people of Cotton Ground, more is on its way. Because as your next representative, I will do much more than I've done over the last 7 years since I've been in the Nevis Island Assembly and Nevis Island government. But I'm not disheartened by anyone who tells me to leave any territory. Every territory here on the island of Nevis belongs to me and belongs to us in the CCM. It also belongs to whoever is in the NRP too, because we are all Nevisians and we can go to the length and breadth of this island. I, for one, will not ever tell anyone in the NRP to leave anyway, any place here on the island of Nevis. Nevis belongs to us. So I want to issue this to the NRP this evening. The entire organization, speak to your foot soldiers. Tell them we are a peaceful community. We are a peaceful island. So much peace is on the island now. When you go to campaign, you do your campaigning. When I go to campaign, leave me alone. I do not go out on the campaign trail to engage anyone in the NRP. I say hello to them. But we have to understand that this is campaigning time. And there's no need for that. There's no need for that here in Nevis. There's no need for that in St. Kitts as well. We can be aggressive in our approach to our supporters, but there's no need for any untowards activities from either side. Let's keep the peace. Let's keep the love, and let us keep the momentum going in this federation under a team unity government that will be ushered in come on the 6th of June. But I start that way, and I also want to say this. I have been bombarded by numerous calls, many calls, from a particular lady by the name of Jasmine Johnson. I have searched the voters list up in St. James. I have searched the voters list in St. Thomas's, and I've never come across such name. I have asked around Nevis, who is Jasmine Johnson? I've gone to the length and breadth of Nevis to ask. I want to say tonight to Jasmine Johnson, stop disturbing me and stop disturbing my phone. Do not call me anymore. What this Jasmine Johnson, I understand, is calling around. She's calling and asking persons in St. James and St. Thomas's to vote for the NRP, to vote for Patrice Nisbet. But I've gotten many different texts from persons who have sent texts to me and said, they have asked this Jasmine Johnson, tell me one thing that Patrice Nisbet has done for the constituency of Nevis 11. And over those conversations, there has not been one reason they have presented or that person has presented for the people of St. James or St. Thomas's to vote for Patrice Nisbet. Give me one reason they have asked, one reason why I should vote for Patrice Nisbet. And the caller have not given one single reason. As a matter of fact, some persons have told me that the caller has hanged up click. And if you think I'm lying, you'll get a call. Some of you would get a call from Jasmine Johnson tomorrow. Because I don't know who it is, I went to the deli up at Best Buy. I went to the deli and asked, do you know Jasmine Johnson? They told me you're at a deli. You're at a deli. People don't understand, but anyway. Oh, somebody said, I went to the deli. They sell what? They sell sliced ham, sliced turkey, sliced cheese. So I went there to buy some deli this morning. And they told me at the deli, they don't know who is Jasmine Johnson. But I leave that. But you know why they're up and down calling persons? The candidate in question cannot face the people of St. James. He cannot face the people of St. Thomas's. So what they're doing? Sending out phone calls. It is such an atrocity. And I tell you before that this election is all about representation. Have you represented the people of St. James? Have you represented the people of St. Thomas's? The answer is no. And that is why he cannot face the people of St. James and St. Thomas's. But the calls can continue. Because all of the persons I've spoken to said they have told him. Or told her. Sorry. This house belonged to Alexis Jeffers. This house belonged to Alexis Jeffers. This house is going to be voting for Alexis Jeffers. This house is blue. And then they called some Spanish as well too. And the Spanish said, Mi casa azul. Mi vota CCM. So even the Spanish is telling them exactly what will happen come election day.
No.
Well, I started that way because I have to do that, you know. We are campaigning. And when you're campaigning, the campaign, I did say earlier I was going to start and be a certain way tonight. But boy, when you get behind these microphones, you just can't be, you just can't be subtle. You can't be anything else but revved up. So we are going to leave that Jasmine Johnson. And I won't go back to the deli to ask the question again. Because it seems as though nobody knows who this young lady is. But I said to that person, St. Thomas and St. James, this time we'll be both voting overwhelmingly for the Concerned Citizens Movement. Nevis 11 this time will be voting overwhelmingly for Alexis Jeffers to ensure that we usher in a brand new representative in that constituency, one who is ready to transform that consistent constituency, one who is ready to reposition that constituency where people will be the focus of our representation or my representation. You have to put people first. People have to come before you. They're the ones who elected you to go there to represent their concerns and to represent them well. But ladies and gentlemen, before I come back to the issue of representation, let me speak a few things here. Because part of the reason why CCM has remained a dominant force on the political landscape here on Nevis is because it is the best party that this island has ever seen. It is the best party that this federation has ever seen and experienced. And why I say that is because of the very fact that I just spoke about. We have always placed people first. People has always mattered most to this party, and that is why we have provided true representation here in Davis and also in the federal parliament. And the reason why we are saying this time around, it is a crucial election that we are facing. We are at the crossroads here in the island of Nevis where as we go to the polls and we vote a certain way, it could determine exactly what happens to this island moving forward. It will certainly determine what happens in this federation moving forward as well. You vote for the CCM, you're keeping us on the right track and heading in the right direction in terms of progress for this island. I want to say to you that the Premier have said it in the past, and I would repeat it. When we decided that after 30 plus years of this great party, we decided that we will form a union with political parties in St. Kitts. Never before in the history of this great party have we done that. But we felt that it was necessary to do so because there were certain forces at work in Bastia that were bringing pain and pressure on the people of Nevis and the government that was duly elected by the people of Nevis. Pain and pressure abound. So we decided in 2013. And we have to remind you because sometimes we can forget easily. We see numerous progresses and we wonder how it came about and we forget how it came about. But in 2013 we decided as a political party we will join with two political parties in St. Kitts. As a result of that, pain and pressure came on us. We have spoken about the bouncing of that check for civil servants and pensioners back in 2014, April to be exact of 2014, when persons were wandering to Charlestown and wondering what has become of their paycheck. What an embarrassment that was. It was an embarrassment to the Nevis Island administration. It was an embarrassment to CCM supporters. It was an embarrassment to NRP supporters. It was an embarrassment to all of us. But we didn't stop there as a party in government. Your CCM party did not stop there. We issued our feelings at that point in time. And we said, never again would anyone sit in Bastia. Never again would any prime minister who do not have any love for the people of Nevis will sit in Bastia and bounce our civil servants' check. Never again are you going to have a representative from the island of Nevis who was a part and parcel of that same decision. Never again will it happen. We decided that. We determined that. But I want to give you a sneak view, a good reason why we came up with that decision. You know, the Bank of Nevis has been with us since 1985. Came under the NRP. And the NRP in government, in and out of government, never, ever at any point, the NRP and its leadership thought about buying one single share in the Bank of Nevis. When shares became available, all of the NRP stalwarts, all of the NRP supporters, the bigwig, whomever had money, they made sure they purchased shares. Well, nothing is wrong with that, I suppose. But here's the difference. Your CCM party, back in 2016, under the leadership of the Honorable Van Samry, determined that we should have a stake as the people of Nevis. In that bank. It is an indigenous bank. The bank belongs to us. So if it belongs to Nevis, if it belongs to the people of Nevis, then the people of Nevis, through its government, must have a stake in that bank. So we bought 2,000 shares. Sorry, back up. That's small. 2 million shares. 2 million shares, and I believe they were valued at just about $3 million. So I want to say to every Nevisian tonight, whether you're down in Hanley's Road, up in Brick Hill, up in Fountain, anywhere on the island of Nevis, you have a stake in the Bank of Nevis through your Nevis Island administration. And that was the thinking of your CCM party in government. We figured then and we determined then that the island of Nevis must be secured through its institutions. And that's why we bought those shares. And you know the interesting thing? We're going to buy more. The NIA will own more shares in the Bank of Nevis. What does that do to the bank? It certainly strengthens the bank. It strengthens a local institution. And it ensures that once that backing is there for that bank, it will survive. But the NRP was not thinking that. That is why we are talking this evening about representation, who have the best interests of the people of Nevis at heart. And when you compare the NRP to the CCM, you understand they are good at lip service, you know, they like to talk. But my thing is, when it comes to representation, it is all about show me what you have done for me lately. And when we decided to buy those shares, it was a quantum leap forward for the Nevis Island administration and its leadership, your CCM party, thinking about the island of Nevis, thinking about the people of Nevis, and securing the future of the island of Nevis. And that we must be applauded for that. I'm hoping persons out there who are viewing are applauding and saying, wonderful, because without that, anyone can treat the Nevis Island Administration as they like. Anyone can. But we said before that we are putting the infrastructure in place and putting all of the necessary things in place to ensure that what happened in 2014 does not happen again. And it was a matter of ensuring we have a stake in that bank, that we have its backing and its support to ensure that our civil servants, our pensioners who look forward to that, those monies at the end of the month to pay their bills, they will not be left out in the cold. And I'm proud of that decision, you know. I'm proud of that decision. I'm proud because when people elect you to serve, to govern, and to look after their best interests, you must be willing to do so. If you're not willing to do so, the people should determine and decide when they go to vote, not you. Let's go with the CCM. But ladies and gentlemen, I put that out there because in Bastia we have shown you and have demonstrated to you that as a party, the CCM party, that we have gone to St. Kitts. We are not only in the federal parliament, but we have been in the federal government. And our exploits as a party in the federal government stands head and shoulder above any other party that have gone there. Well, the only other one is the NRP. We have much to show for that. And the representation that we have received from the Honorable Mark Brantley, the representation that we have received from the Honorable Vance Amory, have been stellar when compared to all who have been there before. And Nevisians must not forget their history. This election is about history. It's about the present. It's about the future. And all of that is wrapped up in one single thing: decent and honest, proper representation. So we have seen over the past where the NRP has been there. And what have they brought? What have they done? They may want to articulate things, but I'm not here to speak for them. They can speak for themselves. I can tell you that with that union, we are now considered not a half a citizen, but a full-fledged citizen of the Federation. Because you know why? Those who have been there before say Nevis no want nothing. So if Nevis no want nothing out of the federal arrangement, it means that you are not in this arrangement or any arrangement to bring back anything to the people of Nevis. So you don't care about the people of Nevis. You don't care if we swim or we sink. You don't care if we survive. But we have determined as a party that once we go across to the federal parliament or the federal cabinet, you will be well represented by your CCM party and its representative or representatives. And the history is there to show that over the past, when the NRP has said that Nevis don't want nothing, between 2006 and 2009, for example, the reports are there to show, well over $229 million in grant funds was poured into the federal coffers. $229 million money came from Japan, money came from Canada, money came from Mexico, grants came from all over the world, Brazil, grants came from Caribbean islands, it came from everywhere. And Nevis received zero, not one thing. There were about 80 or 81 projects that were done during that period of time. Nothing came to the Nevis Island Administration. Nothing. $229 million. At that time, the NRP was in bed with the Labour Party. Lord of mercy, you're in bed lying down, hugging up, kissing up with someone, and they don't even have no respect and regard for you to even give you 5 cents. You could imagine that. And now these people are coming back to us and say, vote for us. Not us, meaning the CCM. Vote for them to go back to do what? To do nothing, to bring back nothing, to not provide any type of representation to transform the lives of anyone on Nevis. You should shun these people. When they come, Don't be afraid to tell them go where they're going. Move along. You're a waste of time. You haven't done anything to deserve any attention from us as voters. And as such, when these calls come to your homes in St. James, in St. Thomas's, Lord, don't be afraid to tell them, listen, I don't want to hear nothing from you. I put it over the best way, locally and colloquially, we talk our dialect. Tell them, I don't want to hear a thing from you. I'm rolling in one direction. I'm rolling with the blue team. I'm rolling with the CCM party. I'm rolling with Alexis Jefferson, Nevis 11. I don't think the calls are going into Nevis 9. I don't know. But if the calls are going into Nevis 9, it's the same answer you should give them. We're rolling with Mark Brantley in Nevis 9. We're rolling with the blue team. We're hammering this time and we're voting for Mark Brantley. I don't want to hear a thing from you.
Mark Brantley.
Same thing up in Nevis 10. Well, Nevis 10, I doubt if they'll ever call up there because I believe, Eric, you have an opponent. But when it's all said and done, such is the opponent. I say I'm not going to say a thing about him anyway. But Eric, the calls won't come. You'll be fine. Eric will be rolling down to Bastia with the blue team. And Eric will win overwhelmingly. But ladies and gentlemen, what are we going to do for Nevis 11? I have said before, and I continue to repeat, that the people of Nevis 11, that is the citizens of Nevis 11, must be proud once again of their representative. They must feel their representative. They must feel that when they cast that ballot or they make that X for a representative, that that representative will do what is mandated to him, and that is to represent. And when I mean represent, I mean that the interests of the people of Nevis 11 will be looked after by Alexis Jeffers to ensure that every citizen in Nevis 11 will be considered to be a part of the national dialogue. The national dialogue when it comes to formation of policies and programs to impact the people of the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. If there are boards, committees that requires a division to be a part of that national board, persons from Nevis 11 will be considered. But in saying that, let me say this to you, that it is a commitment that I can stand by because the examples are there to show. Someone from Nevis 11 is on the SIDF board. Never before in the history of St. Kitts and Nevis, never before in the history of that SIDF was anyone from Nevis on that board. Never before I was able and was instrumental in ensuring that someone from Nevis 11 gets there. That's even before I was ever elected to the federal parliament. So if I make that commitment, it is made on sound and solid foundation that persons from Nevis 11 will be considered. Never before in the history of Nevis 11 or St. James or St. Thomas's have anyone from that constituency been on a board such as Clarence Fitzroy Bryant College board. Right now, there are two persons on that board from St. James. And the people of St. Thomas's need not worry about that because when I sit in the cabinet of the Nevis Island administration, I am always cognizant of the fact that the people of St. James would have voted for me. And I represent them well. But I do represent the whole of Nevis. But on a matter such as that, I said, we have two educators over there who can make a solid contribution to the direction of that particular institution. And they went there and they have made their contribution. Not only that, National Bank Board, someone from Nevis 11 is there as well too. And I want to say that these things are important to consider because what I would have said before, whether you live in Nevis 11, 9 or 10, you're not half of a citizen of the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. You are a full-fledged citizen. You are a citizen who would have been born here, grew up here, live here, been a part of the development of this country, and you must play your part, no matter where you're from. And I don't think anyone should have a problem with this particular type of thinking. Because that is what it should be. If we are a federation, we should operate like a federation, live like a federation, move together as a federation. And of course, once that is done, we will continue to be the envy of the world. That's what we have been. So ladies and gentlemen, let us not forget our history. Let us not forget the things of the past where persons would have gone to St. Kitts. And for some strange reason, they believe that Nevis don't want a thing. This CCM party has always said, we are going to Bastia to seek to bring about and make it happen that the people of Nevis receive their rightful share. And I am proud that based on the numbers I'm seeing, that overwhelmingly all three seats, I said all three for we in 2020, but I want to add, we have a slogan here. The momentum is rolling in favor of the CCM party. And we're keeping the momentum. We're rolling off of the PA in Charleston, or we're going to roll off the PA in Wally, and we're going to roll down to Bastia, roll into the federal parliament, roll into the federal government. We'll keep the momentum going. And once we keep that momentum going, lives and livelihoods here in the island of Nevis will be transformed. And your best interests will be certainly looked after. Ladies and gentlemen, we have quite a number of nights we're going to come back here. I'm not going to bang out my throat tonight.
Big up Alexis Jefferson.
It's just about 10 past 10. But before I go, let me speak. And every night when I come, I have to speak about my leader. And the reason why I'm speaking about my leader and the leadership that he has provided this great party. When the transition was made in 2017, I am certain many persons here on the island of Nevis would have had their doubts. Of course, we would have had 30 years of leadership under the great leadership that is of the Honorable Vance Amory. But the baton was passed on. And of course, I've said before that the Honorable Mark Brantley is not the Honorable Vance Amory. But the comparisons will be made. But based on the leadership that the Honorable Mark Brantley has provided to this great island, I am proud to stand here this evening and say that I have been blessed to be a part of this great party with the Honorable Mark Brantley as the leader this evening and moving forward.
Mark Brantley, are you in any place, you know?
You hear Coffee say? I say every time I hear me talk about Mark you say Coffee say. Coffee stay in Hollywood in Jamaica and say, Mark Brantley, you run the place.
Mark Brantley, are you in any place?
But they don't say a king have no honor in his own country. But that's fine. I am here tonight to tell you and tell the whole world that the Honorable Mark Brantley has demonstrated to the entire island of Nevis, has demonstrated to the entire federation that he is more than capable of leading not only Nevis, but he can lead the federation too. We keep talking about salaries. I'm not going there, but while we are talking about salaries, why aren't the people of Nevis wondering when we are going to have a prime minister from Nevis? I'm not opening a debate tonight. The Constitution allows it. The Constitution allows it. The Constitution, the same way we can receive a paycheck from the NIA, we can receive a paycheck from the federal government, it's the same way anyone, even myself, could be the prime minister of St. Kitts Nevis any day. I am certain someone in St. Kitts is saying, but I think you're right. I think I can. And that is why I'm saying we have to be certain here on the island of Nevis exactly what we're looking for and where we're hoping to take this island. So anyone can be the leader of the federation any day out of Nevis. And we can aspire to that. And I believe the Honorable Mark Brantley has that, the acumen. He has the ability. He has the characteristics. He has whatever it takes to lead any institution on any island, any country, especially the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. And I say that with no other intent other than to say that I am bigging up my leader. So Mark Brantley, I want to commend you thus far. COVID has placed some tests at your feet, and you have demonstrated that you have stood the test of time. Other tests will come, and your leadership will be tested as we go. But I want you to stand firm. Stand firm and press on. Stand firm and press on, because the journey was never going to be easy. But the interesting thing and the good thing is that you have a great team around you. And this team will help to carry you through. You have a great party and great members of this great party who would be there to take you through. But ladies and gentlemen, in closing, let us go out on June 5th. Some persons are saying that they won't be voting in this election. I want to say to you, all of you who are saying you're not going to vote in these elections, I want you to reverse that thinking. Go out and vote in your overwhelming numbers. Go out and vote. This particular voting right was fought for way back in 1948 or thereabout. That was the age and the dawn of adult suffrage. It should not be taken lightly. It is one of those sacred activities that you should take seriously at all times. Go out and vote. But when you go and vote, vote overwhelmingly for your CCM party. Vote overwhelmingly in Nevis 9 for the Honorable Mark Brantley. Send him back to Bastia to continue the representation. Let him go back there and continue to build on the platform as one of the best foreign affairs minister ever seen in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. I want you to go out overwhelmingly and vote overwhelmingly for Eric Evelyn in Nevis 10. He is new, but he will win. And of course, the experience will come as he go. But I see great things ahead for Eric. Vote overwhelmingly for Eric Evelyn in Nevis 10 so that he can continue to build on the platform that his predecessor, prior to him, the Honorable Van Samory, would have done. Vote for Eric. In Nevis 11, I said before I came in 2010, journey started 10 years ago. I came back in 2015, was not successful as well. I'm here again in 2020, and this time we have to usher in a new era in that constituency. For nigh 20 years, 240 months, 7,300 days, you have had a representative in the name and the person of Patrice Nevis who have done nothing, absolutely nothing for the constituency of Nevis 11. And the people that lives in that constituency. I've said not even a war house you can find that man has built. Not even a war house. And those of us who are old enough would know what a war house is. Not even that he has brought to that constituency. So it is time now to change and move in a new direction. Bring about a new change, a new representative. Let's bring a new era and let it dawn in that constituency and bring home Alexis Jeffers come June 5th as your new representative. I want to thank the great people of Nevis 11 in advance. Thank you in advance for your support. Thank you in advance for your vote. You will not be disappointed. I will not fail you. Sound like I'm giving my victory speech. But ladies and gentlemen, that was my quota for tonight. We have many more evenings to come here. Thank you for listening. All of you, they continue to listen and following this great party. We have always put people front and center in what we do. People matters most, and we continue to rumble and keep the momentum all the way into Bastia come June 6th. Thank you for listening. Have a good night. Why?
Darkness walks behind me.
Behind me.
But he will never, 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 never control me. Today I live a life of sorrow, working for the joys of a bright tomorrow. Carrying my cross. Carrying my cross. Carrying my cross. Wisdom, show me.
Thank you very much, Mr. DJ. And thank you very much, Honorable Alexis Jeffers. The next representative of Nevis number 11, St. Thomas's and St. James. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I guess by now, all of us, throughout the length and breadth of Nevis, would have heard the argument that CCM continue to make to ensure that we have the Honorable Alexis Jeffers elected on the 5th of June. We continue to make the case and we continue to make the argument that for 20 years, the NRP representative have not brought back one single thing for the people of Nevis number 11, not even a pencil for a child in one of the primary schools. And we are saying to you, it's time to turn a new page. It's time to turn a new page with the Honorable Alexis Jeffers. Ladies and gentlemen, throughout this campaign, we continue to hear from the other side all kind of denigrating comments. And the last two that have been weighing heavily on my mind came to us very recently. And I want the DJ to play those two statements.
Those house Negroes who are coming to tell people in Bath. These are house Negroes who live in Bath.
That's one. And that is how they are thinking about the people of Bath Village. That is what they are thinking about the people of Bath Village. And when I think about,
oh, you see them coming out, you know, like termites. I can talk about Bath, for example. There are three in particular in Bath. They live in here, and now you see them coming out, you know, like termites.
Now, Bath Village, I hope you are listening. I hope you recognize what it is and how it is that they are thinking about you. This is a man who is coming to you to ask you to give him your support for a job. Now, if I am applying to someone for a job, I would be respectful and humble, but I don't care. And we have seen some very illustrious sons and daughters that came out of Bath Village. We have our ambassador from the OAS, Dr. Hull. He walked the streets of Bath Village barefoot. We have at our Sinkits and Nevis National Bank, here in Nevis and over on Sinkits, two Bath Villagers, Mr. Thompson and Miss Lewis. I hope they don't mind me calling their names. I hope they don't get upset with me. But these are upstanding, illustrious sons and daughters from Bath. We have from Bath internationally recognized umpires. We have from Bath world-renowned chef and Calypsonian in one, all mixed up together, the mighty Black Hat. We have from Bath some of the most talented fishermen you can find anywhere in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. Great teachers, wonderful nurses, marvelous athletes from that place that we call the Tropolis of Bath. And I'm saying to Bath Village, you have as your representative at this moment a man who will never ever insult you. You have at the moment a representative who on a daily basis continue to uplift the people of Bath. Ladies and gentlemen of Bath Village, you have a decision to make. And I am suggesting to you that on the 5th of June, you send a very clear message to the NRP that this kind of language will not be tolerated on any political platform on the island of Nevis. I want the people of Bath to go to the polls and vote overwhelmingly for the Honorable Mark Brantley. He has stood with you, and he will continue to stand with you. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome to the microphone our Premier, your representative of Bath Village, the Honorable Mark Brantley, to address you.
I'm the leader of the Concerned Citizens Movement Party, and I will be contesting in the constituency of number 9, where I am currently in government, and I'm asking the people of number 9 to stick with me and to keep the momentum. In 2015, the Concerned Citizens Movement took a decision to join the people of...
Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. Welcome one and all to all of those who are listening via the World Wide Web, those who are on Facebook, those who are listening to VON Radio, those who are on our YouTube channel. Good evening to everyone. I want to thank the few supporters who were able to come to be here with us at campaign headquarters tonight. I want to thank my colleagues, those who have been on this platform, the Honorable Troy Liebert, the Honorable Spencer Brand, who has hosted this for us, and of course, the Honorable Eric Evelyn and Alexis Jeffers, our two candidates who, in addition to me, make up the team that will be going to St. Kitts on the 6th of June. When we're elected on the 5th of June, we'll be going over on the 6th of June to represent the people of Nevis. I believe that we are a good team. I believe that we are a team that embodies the best that Nevis has to offer at this point in time. And I believe that as a team, we have a record that we are proud of, a record of accomplishments that is unmatched. Ladies and gentlemen, every election is a contest. Every election, you must choose between one team and the next, between one candidate and the next. And I ask you to match up the candidates. Look at them, examine them, examine their records in public life. Look at them, and then look at the teams, and look at the ideas, look at the representation, look at the competence. And I believe if you do all that, there could be only one conclusion, that the Concerned Citizens Movement, this big blue machine, this beautiful team, this party that has served the people of Nevis so well, that it is the best team to represent the people of Nevis. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to take an opportunity tonight, because as I've been going out in the highways and the byways, have we been engaging with our people on their doorsteps, at the shops, and wherever else we meet our people. We are having the necessary conversations, and we're hearing from them and getting the feedback. And I'm here to say that the feedback thus far has been overwhelmingly positive. I am to encourage all of our people to go out and vote. I spoke to a beautiful lady as I went around in the community. And I said to her, I'm asking for your support. She said to me, you are doing a wonderful job. This government has performed incredibly well. I have no criticisms whatsoever. The way you've handled this COVID-19 pandemic was better than even in the great United States of America. And I said to her, I look forward to your support on June 5th. And she said to me, I don't think I will be voting. I said, but you said that you are very happy with the government. She said, yes, but you are going to win anyway. So I don't think I need to go. And I said to her, no, because we can be sure that the NRP supporters are going to go to vote. So each and every one of us who support this party, each and every one of us who wants the best representation for Nevis, you too must go out and vote. Make your vote count. Your forefathers would have suffered and sacrificed to give you that right to vote. I appeal especially to our young people, many who like to say, we're not interested in politics, and I'm here to tell you, politics affects everything you do. Politics impacts you, because when you have a bad government, you are adversely affected. When crime and criminality was on a rampage in this country, when crime and criminality were on a rampage on the island of Nevis, who suffered most? The young people. Who suffered most? Our young men, and on occasions, our young women. Who were going to prison? Our young people. Who are dying in our streets, our young people. And look now at the peace that has come. The peace that we are so grateful to God for. That all of us now feel safer in our homes. And our young people can go and play cricket. They can go and play football. They can engage at the bar. They can go out and hang out as young people should without fear. Without fear of crime. That, ladies and gentlemen, is good governance at work. That is good government to the rescue, to try and bring relief and solve a situation that has been with us for nigh 20 years. In 5 years, we have made that difference through the grace of God and the excellent leadership that we have had in the country. And so I say to our people, please go out and vote. Do not sit back at home and say, oh, CCM don't win. No. Make your mark. Go out and make a difference and ensure that you do not gamble. You do not gamble. You do not give those that you know to be incompetent the opportunity to serve you in Bastia. You look at the record and you recognize that the NRP was in office first with PAM from 1981 until 1995. And they got in again with Labour this time from 2010 until 2015. By my math, 1981 to 1995, that's 14 years. And then 2010 to 2015 is another 5. They have had 19 years in government. 19 years sitting at the table. 19 years sitting at the cabinet level, and you ask yourself, what does Nevis have to show for those 19 years? What does Nevis have to show for those 19 years? If you could answer that question and point out to me what the NRP, who were first in bed with PAM, then in bed with Labour. Next thing they're going to be bed with CCM. What have they achieved in 19 years? And the answer, my friends, is nothing. They can't show, they can't point to it, they can't tell us what they've accomplished. But look at the Concerned Citizens Movement. We did not join with anybody. For quite some time, we decided that we'd focus exclusively on the island of Nevis. And then in 2013, an arrogant prime minister with an NRP Labour-led administration in Bastia sought to put pressure on us in Nevis. And CCM took a decision that since you are bringing the fight to us in Charlestown, we will take the fight to you in Bastia. And we took the fight to them in Bastia. And the historians, when they write the history, will say that CCM was successful.
Yeah.
And ladies and gentlemen, I am very proud of that. I reminded someone recently that when others might have been timid, the big blue machine stepped up. And when we won the election up here in 2013, we won against the might of the Labour Party. They had sent all their activists, all their money, everything they had sent here to Nevis against us. And we persevered and we triumphed as a CCM party. And when we beat them in Nevis, somebody called me and said, PAM people in Sinkins had motorcade. You hear what I tell you? When CCM beat NRP with all the assistance that they had from Labour in 2013, they had motorcade down in Sinkins. You know why? Because in Sinkins they understood that we of the CCM had delivered the first installment of Operation Rescue. We had delivered the first installment to take our country back. And having delivered the first installment here in Charlestown, we went down to Sinkins, and in 2015, we delivered the final installment to remove that government down there that had declared war on the people of Nevis. You have heard my colleagues talk about the bouncing of checks, a situation where the hostility that came to us from Bastia because a little short man down there decided that he must decide who governs the island of Nevis. And we said to them, nobody decides that but the people of Nevis. And the people of Nevis choose and chose and will continue to choose the Concerned Citizens Movement. The best party. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I will get to the record. My time here won't be long tonight, but I want to say a couple of things. You see, yesterday I was served. The bailiff called me. He said, where are you? I have something urgent I want to serve on you. I said, well, I'm at my home. He said, I'll come in here in 10 minutes. And he was there, lickety-split, blowing at the gate. When I go to the bailiff, he gave me some papers. The papers are a lawsuit brought by one Dr. Kelvin Daly and one Janice Williams. Janice Williams of Brownhill, Kelvin Daly of Parts Unknown. And the two of them bring this big lawsuit, disturb me home, trying to get an hour's rest before I go back to the campaign trail. What are they saying in this lawsuit? They said they want to be added as parties to the boundaries case that was filed in 2015, 5 years ago. They say that the Douglas boundaries should now be brought into effect. They say that I have an unfair advantage because number 9 is so big compared to number 10. They say that they want 3,000 people from number 9 to move up to Gingerland. They say that poor Janice have anxiety because she don't know where she's supposed to vote. She don't know whether it's 10 or 9, so she have anxiety. My little advice to you, Janice, if you got anxiety, go look for your doctor. Go look for your doctor, because courthouse can't solve anxiety, you know. Anxiety, you need a therapist. Go look for your doctor. Oh,
no,
but that.
No.
This laughter here always cracking up, you know. Go look for your doctor. If you are anxious, she don't know where she's supposed to vote. Mine, I moved Brownhill, meet Janice in Brownhill, you know. I'm a hard, hard gray man now of 51. So Janice got to be grayer than me. And Janice say, she don't know where she's supposed to vote. But you hear what the issue is now? The issue is that the NRP is saying to the people of Cox, the people of Coal Hill, the people of Church Ground, the people of Montpelier, Brown Hill, the people of Victoria Road, they're saying to you that you must go Gingerland to vote. Gingerland to vote. And you have to ask yourself the question, why? But you know why? They understand that the people of St. John's have time and time again rejected the Nevis Reformation Party. The people of St. John's have time and time again said that their preferred choice is the Concerned Citizens Movement. And so they want to take off half of St. John's, send the good people into Gingerland. And then now, they say, St. Paul's remains, and we have a little piece of St. John's to contend. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been a lawyer for long enough to know that it is foolhardy to predict what a judge will do. So somebody called me today, the press called me, they say, what are your thoughts? I say, I have no thoughts. My job is to campaign to the people of Nevis and the people of Number 9. I will go house to house. I will go street by street and village by village. And at the end of the day, I will win the election. You know why? Because boundaries have never voted a day in their life. Boundaries don't vote. People vote. So I don't care what boundaries they come with. I don't care if on the 5th of June they tell me that it is the people of St. James that have to vote for me. I don't care if they tell me it's Booby Island I have to go to be elected. I am saying wherever they send me, the people of Nevis recognize leadership. They recognize good representation. And whatever the boundaries, this Concerned Citizens Movement will prevail. The reason for that is simple. That we are represented in such a way that the people of Nevis understand that what we say is what we mean, and what we mean is what we say. We don't come on the platform to cuss nobody. We don't call the people of Bath Village house Negroes and termites. We are not in that, because we come instead to discuss our record.
House Negroes, we're coming to tell people in Bath. These are house Negroes who live in Bath.
Listen to them, angry people. You know, I was in Sinkins one time, and a taxi man said to me, the CFBC fella, because that's what they call him down there, the CFBC fella was on radio again cussing you. I said, well, that's his job. And then the guy said to me, why is he so angry? Why is he so angry? They never had friends when they were young. They never played little cricket and pitch marble. They don't know how to relate to people. Why are they so angry? Somebody told me that they're going house to house with him because he has some of my people walking with him and taking his money. And the person told me I will go house to house with him. And he said the minute that somebody challenges him, he starts to cuss the people. Flounce off and cuss the people. And it comes out every time. That is why when he was speaking and spewing the usual rhetoric, the nonsense, the lies, and the anger is coming out, Bijan put back his head and went to sleep. Even Bijan said, me not got no time with this foolishness here. I might as well take a nap. So ladies and gentlemen, that is what the NRP has brought to us. Anger, venom. That is what, and you ask yourself, If them man they're so vexed and they're not in government, where they have no power to do anything to anybody, you could imagine if they ever got their hands on the reins of government in this island, well, it'll be hell to pay the priests. Tutmon Samambagai gonna be under pressure here because they're vexed with the world. Now, if I find myself at 60 and the only thing that I've achieved is nothing, I have nobody to blame but me. So who they vex with? Who they vex with? Because when they stand up, they tell you how bright they are. But they can't show you what they've achieved with all the brightness that they have. And they are upset with themselves because they do not feel that they are where they should be. And that venom keeps coming out. So with their foulness, can call the people a bad host Negro. And then afterwards, they're trying to justify it, you know. Talking about host Negro and field Negro. I tell them, listen, host Negro and field Negro, all of them were slaves.
I can talk about Bath, for example. There are three in particular in Bath. They live in here. And now you see them coming out, you know, like termites.
That is the language used to describe our people. Whether you're host Negro or field Negro, all of them were slaves. That was the language of slavery. And I don't know nobody in Bath is a slave. I don't know nobody in Nevis is a slave. The people of Nevis, the people of Bath are proud people. That is why I liked that the Honorable Spencer Brand took some time just to highlight a few, because there's so many Bath villagers who have done so well, excelled in every facet of human endeavor. And to be caricatured in this way by a failure, I said to myself, that is unacceptable. Unacceptable. So that is what they're bringing to us. No ideas. They have none. They go on Google, they take up a picture off Google, and they tell Nevisions, look here, this is what we're going to do. Well, they don't know all the young people in Nevis know how to Google. All the young people know how to Google. So the minute they drop the picture, somebody say, boy, that they look like a something they do in New Zealand. Same thing, no ideas, because they clearly have not thought this through. Now I hear them today say that if they are elected, mind you, this is a federal election, you know. They say if they're elected, everybody in Nevis is going to get a duty-free car. And I said to myself, do they understand that duty-free in Nevis is granted by the Nevis Island Administration? Do they understand that? And that is why I'm saying they are running this kind of campaign, which is designed to confuse people. And I have made bold to say, because it is so, that once God gives us life and gives us strength, on the 6th of June, Mark Brantley will still be the Premier of Nevis. Eric Evelyn, Alexis Jeffers, Spencer Brand, Hazel Brandy Williams, Troy Liebert, we will still be in the cabinet of the Nevis Island Administration. And I think our people need to understand that is why there's a difference between local issues for a local election and federal issues for a federal election. So let me get to the federal issues. And let me get to the level of representation. You all remember there was something called the SIDF. The SIDF was where all the passport money went. King Bingy, one of my favorite Calypsonians, sang a song. You remember? We want the SIDF money. I'm sure the whole world remembers King Bingy's hit. We want the SIDF money. You know why the Calypsonian ball out? Because under NRP and Labour, Nevis got nothing from the SIDF. Nothing. We did not even have a representative on the board of the SIDF. And I want you to consider that. They now argue, having received nothing when they were at the table, that CCM, they say, get $200 million and they vex. They vex, as you say, they blue vex. Well, why should they be vexed that the people of Nevis have finally been able to access something from their own passport money? Well, the people of Nevis aren't citizens in the country. The passport not say St. Christopher and Nevis. So the money must just come in and go Bastia and stay in Bastia. But let me tell you something, you know. It speaks to their lack of representation, their inability to negotiate, their lack of interest on the part of the people of Nevis. Because look at it. Look at it. I have in front of me here the financial statements for the SIDF. And I want this, I want you to listen carefully. Those of you who are online, this is the NRP record with Patrice Nisbet, who comes yet again to the people of number 11, asking after 20 years for another chance. He wants 25. He wants 25 years because he's telling you to give him another 5 years. And you ask the question, Patrice, what have you done? Well, I have the accounts in front of me for the SIDF as at December 31st, 2013. A time when Patrice Nisbet and the NRP were at the table in the cabinet as part of the Douglas NRP administration. Lord, the figures are worthwhile looking at. 2013, they have a heading, grants and donations. Grants and donations. They have grant here. Government of St. Kitts and Nevis, school improvement project, 10 million. Small Enterprise Assistance Fund, SEAF, 10 million. Warner Park upgrade, 9.4 million. Infrastructure development road projects, 8 million. Residential solar panels, you hear that? Residential people down there had solar panels for their house paid for by the SIDF. 6 million. Community infrastructure upgrade, 2.7 million. Schools information communication technology integration project, 2.6 million. Bastia public market modernization, 2.2 million. St. Kitts and Nevis 30th anniversary independence celebration, $2 million. Disaster relief for St. Vincent and St. Lucia, $995,000. Tropical Bontic treatment, $920,000. Closed circuit TV systems, $602,000. Livestock genetic pool expansion project, $391,160. Youth skills training, $126,000. National infrastructure improvement, $92,000. Youth empowerment summer camp, $75,500. Coconut Palm Rehabilitation Project, $18,000. They go down further here. They say, St. Kitts Electricity Company Limited. Oh my goodness. $31,235,743. Agriculture Resource Management, $4,034,000. St. Christopher ANC Post Authority, SCASPA, $1,776,121. You hear all what I call out there? The grand total was $93,419,263. $93,419,263 in grants and donations. That is free money to St. Kitts for the year ended December 31st, 2013. When Patrice Nisbet and the NRP was sitting at the table with Denzel Douglas and Labour. All of them together, one government. 93 million, let me speak properly. 93,419,263. That is what was spent in free money, grants and donations in St. Kitts. It didn't end there. They had an extra $1.5 million. You know where that went? St. Kitts Music Festival. $537,640, St. Kitts Music Festival Committee. And then $17,250 under category other donations. For a further sum of $2,054,890. For a grand total, ladies and gentlemen, a grand total for the year ended December 31st, 2019. of grants and donations, free money to St. Kitts of $95,474,153. $95,474,153 in the year 2013. The year 2013, these are documents from the accounts of the SIDF. So for the year 2013, bear in mind, I repeat, that Patrice Nisbet and the NRP were at the table. At the table, sitting with Douglas and bawling, comrade. Comrade, they were sitting at the table in Bastia. And while they were there sitting, St. Kitts got $95,474,153 in free money, grants and donations. But let me go on. During the same period, the accounts have another heading, you know, loans receivable. Loans receivable. And then I see the Nevis Island Administration. And let me read, because I want all of you watching and listening to hear me clearly. And listen me clearly. Loans receivable. Nevis Island Administration. And let me read verbatim. On September 28th, 2012, the foundation, that is the SIDF, granted a loan to the Nevis Island Administration in the amount of $6 million, bearing an interest rate of 5% per annum for a period of 5 years. The purpose of the loan was to finance capital projects. It goes on December 14th, 2012, the foundation further granted a loan in the amount of $4,084,000 with an interest rate of 6% per annum. So the interest gone up. Repayable in 60 equal installments to commence within 30 days after the final disbursement of the loan. The purpose of the loan was to assist in purchasing Nevis Airport lands for the airport's expansion and improvement. Now, ladies and gentlemen, and the people of Nevis, I want you to understand what I'm saying to you tonight. That in 2013, when the NRP and Labour were in bed together, when NRP people up and down Nevis calling each other comrade, that the great island of St. Christopher was able to get from our passport money $95,474,153 in raw, hard, cold cash, free. F-R-E-E, free. SIDF gave them the money, and they said, grant, G-R-A-N-T, and donation. You know when you have a little card and you go around, and you beg donation? Free money. $95,474,153. Then you come over to Little Nevis, where the NRP is from, where Patrice Nisbet is from, and all Nevis could get over the same period of time is $6 million as a loan at an interest of 5%, repayable over 5 years, and then another loan of $4,084,000 payable at 6% interest. And that second loan was the one that went to Craft House, except for payment of the airport lands. Reflect with me that over the period, Nevis got $10,084,000 loan. One at 6%, one at 5%. So our passport is negotiated by the team of Labour and NRP. Money comes into the country as a result of the passport investment program. And the people of St. Kitts benefit to the tune of $95,474,153 in grant and donation. Grant and donation. When power up here going off all the time, Skellack, got $31,235,743 free. Skellig, hold a little $31 million here. That for you. Music festival, $1.5 million free. Hold that. Music festival committee, $537,000. Hold that. And it goes on and on. Imagine $6 million spent in sinkets to put solar panel on people's house. Well, sun not shine in Nevis too. Sun don't shine in Nevis. And a Nevis man is sitting at the table. Sitting at the table. The only thing that the NRP could negotiate from the SIDF in 2013 was loans. L-O-A-N. And when they gave the first one at 5%, somebody tell them that too low. So the second one, they carried it to 6%. That is the legacy of NRP. That is the legacy. When you have no representation, you think I could sit down at any table in Bastia and see 94 million pass over my head? And I'm sitting down there and say, please give me a loan. I beg you, give me a loan from my passport money. You hear how I put it? My passport money. And this is what the people of Nevis must bear in mind. I believe we have to find somewhere to upload these numbers here so people could see the actual report on Facebook and think for themselves. Because when this NRP comes to you, tell you, give them another chance. Patrice says, I don't have 20 years, give me another 5. And you say, but Patrice, where were you? You were sleeping like Bichon? Or you just did not care? Where were you? We know that you were busy getting a job for your partner, Hector. We know that. We know you and Hector were busy getting some land up in West Bastia. We know that. But Lord, even if you did those two things, what about the people that sent you to sinkets? What about the people that asked for your representation? For you to be their voice? Well, where were you when in sinkets they were giving away solar panel for people's roof? Yeah, you might be right, you didn't have a roof. But where were you? Where were you to say the good people of number 11, the people of Jessup's, Barnsgut, Westbury, the people of Cotton Ground, the people of Brick Hill and Butlers, Newcastle, that they deserve something too from their passport money? Mind, this money ain't come from some asset in sinkets that was sold, you know. This did not come from some sugar lands in sinkets that was sold. This came from our passport. And sinkets in 2013 could walk away with $95,474,153. And poor Nevis get 2 loans. Think about these things, ladies and gentlemen. The record is there. The record is there, speaking to the absence of representation. Now CCM has gone on for 5 years. Vance and I. And we say, hey, the water taxi operators in Nevis need a home. $6 million for the water taxi pier. We say, hey, Alexandra Hospital, we need some help up there. I think that was $9 million, if memory serves. We say, hey, we need a generator up at Nevlek. $5 million US, $13.5 million. We didn't stop there. We say, hey, we want $6.5 million to rebuild the treasury that somebody burned up. We didn't stop there. We say we need some funds because so we need to do some work at Vance Amory Airport. NASPAM needs some security equipment. We said the people over here must enjoy the same double salary that the fellows in sinkets are enjoying 4 years in a row. We were at the table, and we were at the table for the benefit of the people that sent us there, the people of Nevis. And I make bold to say tonight, you know, right on this platform here, that the people of Nevis should not have to pay back a red cent to the SIDF. We shouldn't have to. because it is morally reprehensible for the people of St. Kitts to get free money and the people of Nevis to get loan from our own passport money. We should not have to pay back a red cent because it is palpably unfair that you could walk away $95+ million and you tell us we must take a loan. Well, what happened? We're not citizens in this country. We're not citizens in this country. And that is why, ladies and gentlemen, I say that Nevis needs strong representation, because we have seen what happens when people go to Bastia to serve themselves and not the people of Nevis. And I challenge anyone out there, any young voter, anybody who's looking for a reason to choose to look at these kinds of things that occurred to the people of Nevis under the watch of the NRP and Labour. Bouncing checks was bad. It affected the civil servants, Labour and NRP supporters, I'm sorry, CCM and NRP supporters alike. But they didn't care. They wanted to embarrass Van Samry. They wanted to embarrass CCM. But who God bless, no man curse. And we stood up then, and through the grace of God, we are standing now. And I tell you that we are stronger than ever in the Concerned Citizens Movement, because the people of Nevis know and understand that in this big blue team, they are the best representation, people that will stand for them. And so long as I, Mark Anthony Graham Brantley, have breath, I will stand up for the people of Nevis. And nobody going to think they're going to take advantage of me because me didn't go to school in August. Didn't go Saturday afternoon either. Sometime I went Sunday. But that's a different kind of school. The people of Nevis must demand representation. That is what this election is about, you know. Who do you have confidence in that is going to stand up, whether it's in Bastia, Tabernacle, Cairn, Sandy Point, it doesn't matter. Who's going to stand up and say, I am here on behalf of the people of Nevis? And who it hurt. Because that is your job. I never vex yet with Timothy Harris when he come and say he come to stand up on behalf of the people of Molyneux. He said, I come to talk for the people of Taba. He right? I them send him. When Lindsey Grant come and he start to say he come on behalf of the people of Old Road, he right, is them send him. Well, I ask a question rhetorically. When Patrice Nisbet was there, who sent him? And on whose behalf did he come? Because the only thing he was interested in is giving, what do you say, he's Starsky and Heck, there's Hutch, giving Hutch a job. And ensuring that he and Hutch get some land in West Bastia. All of self and none of thee. That is the problem that the NRP has. And that is why I said, look at our record and examine our record. And we could go down the line. Patrice was foreign minister. Not a soul from Nevis did he hire in the foreign ministry. Not a soul. You know, I'm going to share a story with you. I don't know if I shared it before, but if I did, forgive me, I'll share it again. When I became foreign minister, the permanent secretary, whom I inherited, came to me, and he said that they had organized already a mock OAS assembly for young people. Now, the OAS is based in the United States. And you go there in Washington, D.C. for the meetings. And they have the OAS assembly, of course, with foreign ministers and prime ministers and things, they go. This was a mock OAS assembly for youth, young people. And I said, brilliant idea. She said, Minister, you're going to continue with it. Your predecessor, Patrice Nisbet, was involved in organizing. And I said, absolutely, it's a good idea. Because I'm not a petty person. And if I see something that I think has benefit, I said, yes, it's a good idea. And so she brought to me all the work that had been done thus far, all the preparatory work. And I'm going through the document, and I see that because it's for youth, they had extended invitations. Well, every high school in Sinkis was invited. Not one student from Nevis was on the list. Not one. And I said to the permanent secretary, I said to her, P.S., you forget the schools in Nevis, you know. We have the Sixth Form. We have Gingerland. We have Charlestown. Those schools must be included. We have the, what's it called, the Nevis International School. They have to be included. And the P.S. clearly had not had attention directed to that. And I reflected because I didn't hold the P.S. responsible. I said, but the man who was presiding over this was a Nevis man. And he did not insist that a single young person from Nevis would be invited to be a part of this mock assembly to rub shoulders with their friends from Mexico, their counterparts from Chile, Argentina, Brazil, United States, Canada. Did not see it fit, and that is why I say, and I say it with all the conviction that I have, that Patrice Nisbet never had the interests of the people of Nevis at heart. Never had the interests of the people of Nevis at heart. I don't mean to spend so much time talking about the gentleman, but I wanted to just set out some of those things, because when we bring a man like Alexis Jeffers, a proven hard worker, a man who could look around Nevis and even in his short time in government can point and say, my DNA is all over the island of Nevis. A man who has had the confidence already at the federal level that as minister in the local assembly responsible for agriculture, he's called upon time and time again at the federal level to travel to represent the federation. Just like Eric Evelyn, called upon as Minister of Culture at the NIA to lead the delegation for Sinkits and Nevis, and is the best delegation that was ever led to carry Festa. By far, a man walk up an aisle with Destra. By far, it tells you that even before they are in the federal cabinet, even before they're in the federal parliament, these two gentlemen are already representing us federally and demonstrating that they have what it takes. No question whatsoever about competence. No question about their ability. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is what this election is about. It's a contest between two teams, between candidates, between ideas, between parties, between ideology. And the ideology of the Concerned Citizens Movement is always to put the people of Nevis first. People matter most. It is how we live. It is what we do. And the evidence is there to show that we have delivered. We have delivered. As foreign minister, I can point to so much. My proudest moments, and when I pick up the phone and I can speak to an ambassador born right here in Nevis and giving the Federation the best representation. You know why it makes me feel proud? Because until I became foreign minister and until CCM became part of the federal government, it had never happened in the history of our country. Now what? Nevis people got Kokobe? Nevis people have Kokobe? Nevis people never went to school and got their degree. Dr. Everson Hull, I want to call his name. Dr. Everson Hull, our ambassador to the OAS, was the first PhD in economics from the great Howard University. Imagine that, reflect on it. A man from Bath Village, the first PhD in economics from Howard University in the United States of America was Dr. Everson Hull. And it took a CCM government and Mark Brantley as foreign minister to say to someone of his acumen and ability that you're good enough to be our ambassador. They had some before who were nowhere near as qualified as Dr. Hull. But Dr. Hull was from Nevis. And the attitude that has existed towards Nevisions is that we were not good enough. And we say we are as good as and better than most. CCM will stand up for the people of Nevis. And where Nevis is strong, Thinkits is strong. And where Thinkits is strong, the Federation is strong. And the only way that we are going to build the type of country that we need is for us to draw on all the talents that are available in our country. Not some. The young boy from Jessup's or Cotton Ground. The young boy from Andes Road or Zion. The young boy from Church Ground or Bath should grow up knowing that he has the same opportunities as his counterpart from Keon, from Sandy Point, from Tabernacle. The young girl who comes from Rowland Mountains in Nevis must know that she has the same potential and the same opportunities as a young girl who's born in the mountains of Phillips's and Thinkits. If we are to build a country that we want and the country that we are proud of and the country that lives up to its motto and its creed, then all of us have to be given an opportunity in this country. And I am proud, ladies and gentlemen, that the party that I now lead and the party that is the Concerned Citizens Movement has always put the people of Nevis first and has always stood up for our people. And the evidence is clear. And I'm telling you, as I stand here tonight, the proud leader of this party, the proud representative of the people of Number 9, and as I encourage our people to vote overwhelmingly for the Concerned Citizens Movement candidates, Eric Evelyn in 10, Alexis Jeffers in 11, and Mark Brantley in 9, as I stand here, I tell you, at no point could I sit at any table where the people of Nevis were being disadvantaged. Couldn't happen. It will not happen. And that is what you want and you need in representatives. People who will stand up for you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there's a lot that I have to say. I can't say it all tonight. We will come back tomorrow. And we'll come back the day after. And we'll be in the byways and the highways because I'm walking. If you all see me looking a little slim, I hope I'm losing weight. Because I'm walking, and I'm talking to people. I'm jumping, oh yes, when the music plays, because everybody say the song must come back for Road March. Eric is the only man in the world I know who say Culturama postpone. Boy, Culturama cancel. Imagine Culturama should have been this year. And because of COVID, the man telling people Culturama postpone until next year. Eh? Culturama cancel until next year. But Culturama next year, I believe that Keep the Momentum should be on the road. This song's sweet. And just to tell you the potential, you know who did the song? A young man called Hashim. Father from Bath, you know? Father from Bath, mother from Trinidad. Young Nevision, because he got Nevision blood in him. Did this song Keep the Momentum and did it for us. Talent galore exists on this little island, ladies and gentlemen. And what you need, and what our people need, is a government and leadership that recognizes that talent, that harnesses that talent, and that puts that talent to work to advance our little island and our little country. And that is why the CCM is asking for your support. The CCM is asking for your support because we have what it takes to lead, and we have demonstrated our capacity to lead. And the record is there to prove it. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back tomorrow. I'm asking you to tune in even greater numbers because I have gone into my grip for this SIDF document. I'm going to go back in the grip and bring the CFBC document because I've been talking about it for a while and I believe it is time that we shed some light on what happened at the Clarence Fitzroy Bryant College. It is important. I like too much a melee. All night I are quiet. The minute I talk about grip, I poke up and start to say, that's what you want to hear. I'm going to bring it because it is important that those who are coming to ask for your vote. Remember, when you vote for somebody, you have to say you have confidence in them, you know. And you must ask, what is their record? And I have said loudly and clearly, as the premier of Nevis, the buck stops with me. And if tomorrow you hear that money gone missing, I don't care whether I was asleep, I was in America when he went missing, I was wherever, the buck stops with me. I'm the leader. I'm in charge. And when you're in charge, when good come, you take the credit, you know. You know how many times I see us jump up here and say, this student is a state scholar, and we feel like we write the exam. We jump up every time our debating team wins the Leeward Island Championship as if we were on the stage debating. We like to take the credit when things go good. Well, when things go bad, who must take the blame? And I will bring the record from the auditor's report that confirmed in black and white for all to see and all that have eyes to read that monies disappeared from CFBC on a daily basis. That some went weekly and some went monthly. But whether daily, weekly, or monthly, monies disappeared. It was a daily occurrence. Monies disappeared from CFBC. And I'm going to bring the figures, just like I brought the figures tonight. Imagine at CFBC, you had credit card, and they're paying credit card, but they don't have any bills. They have no indication of what the credit card bill was for. No supporting documentation, but money's paid out. Imagine at CFBC, nobody was paying Skellig for electricity. They take out the people money who worked there but did not pay to Social Security. Ladies and gentlemen, when you are in a position of leadership, you must take the good and the bad. Good come, you take the credit. Bad come, you must get the blame. And if you're not ready for that, then you're not ready for leadership. Because that is the nature of leadership. So I will come and I will bring the CFBC report from the grip. And we will go through and we look at the numbers and the figures. And we'll ask the question of what monies were spent and what were they spent on. I don't know. You think P.S., former P.S. Evelyn, that maybe the roofing material came from CFBC? Boy, I tell you, we will examine it because all of us have a record and that must be what we must examine. Ladies and gentlemen, the night has grown late. It is time, I believe, that we go away from this place. I want to ask all the supporters of this party to speak to your neighbors and your family members, to speak to your friends. Encourage them to go out and vote in their numbers on June 5th. Speak to those around you. You have to help us to campaign to ensure that our people come out to vote, because I know that once the blue machine cranks up, there is no force on this island that can stop it. And so we are asking you to ensure that we get out that support and those voters go out to vote to ensure that we keep the momentum. That the momentum that we have had in this party and in this island and this country, we continue to keep that momentum. Ladies and gentlemen, that is my quota. We'll be back tomorrow night at the same time right here at campaign headquarters. We will bring new information when we come back. And I look forward to engaging with you again and again and again to make the case over and over, to set out our record, but also to set out our plans, and to say that we of the Concerned Citizens Movement, Alexis Jeffers, Eric Evelyn, Mark Brantley, we represent the best hope for the island of Nevis at this time. And so we ask you, therefore, to send us to Sinkins, send us to Church Street to represent you, because we are going down to represent you in government, and we will do it because that is what we do. Good representation, competent, honest, decent representation. Men who can say before God and man, our hands are clean. Thank you, good night, and God bless you.
They are top 10 more. We voted for CCM again. CCM go keep it up. CCM keep up the momentum. Keep it up.
G-Man, on federal election day, we vote in Premier Mark Brantley and the entire CCM party in seats 9, 10, and 11 for United St. Kitts and Nevis. Ha!
Yeah. They are top 10 more. We voted for CCM again. CCM go keep it up. Just keep it up.